post office.
So, I don't know if you're able to.
Holy shit!
It's actually, is that a lawman? No, it's not a lawman.
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, just saying that. They're also looking for Miles, and they were quite sinister about it. So.
Howdy!
Hey, can I bother you people for a second?
Okay.
Sure.
That person.
Would any of you be interested in buying a canteen?
No, you're at a blacksmith. We sell canteens, do you want to buy one?
You all sell them?
Shit.
Yeah, we sell them ourselves.
For how much do we sell them?
$40.
Yeah. $40? Ah, nice. I sell them for 50. I buy them for 30 though. I respect you also.
Yeah, thank you, thank you.
Are you a different blacksmith?
Sorry?
Are you a different blacksmith from a different town?
No, I buy from a blacksmith. I buy him in bulk from a blacksmith friend of mine. Listen, I will stay out of sale of strawberry in that case. If you are
back
selling here, I'm most of the time selling Saint Denis, but I won't sell about strawberry anymore.
Okay,
keep
thank
it out nicely.
Thank you, thank you.
Yeah.
You too, thank you very much. I respect you also, God bless you, and have a good day.
You too.
They shot down him, they almost hit me with a bullet. I don't know how you stay so calm the whole time.
I don't know how you do it.
What do you mean?
He's trying to sell canteens in this town while there's blacksmiths around.
Well, if you're very nice, you know, I'm kind of also being a little, giving a little attitude by saying, no, we sell canteens, do you want to buy one? You know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's people that are looking for Miles, it's Frankie, you don't have to worry.
Okay.
Something happened.
Are you talking about what happened yesterday? Because I know what happened.
No, it happened today.
With Frankie and him?
No, not with Frankie and Miles, but it happened... I don't know. All I know is that I think Frankie was looking for Miles. Then stuff what happened like an hour later with other people.
Okay, have you seen Frankie?
Yes, earlier, but I think something's happening. So, I don't know.
Okay. Well, thank you for telling me, because I was getting worried.
Yeah, I'm 90% sure it's Frankie looking for him, because he came in asking earlier for him, I think.
Okay.
So, I don't want to tell you that, so you don't do anything stupid.
Thank you.
Okay.
I'm not gonna do anything stupid.
You've got a bit of a weird look in your eye.
I'm gonna go take a nap for like an hour and be back in a minute.
You mean kind of my disability?
do you have any canteens on you? Can you carry multiple canteens?
Yeah,
I can give you 30 if you want.
That way I can sell if anyone comes over?
Yeah.
And it is $40, right?
Fuck you, just I'm Irish.
Okay.
Can't.
You fucking suit me.
Canteens, yeah.
Maybe you can't.
I have an English accent because I studied in England.
No, you can't, I guess, anymore. What the heck? Yeah,
okay.
But I guess you can't anymore. Come on. Thank you, Anna.
Of course.
Oh, yeah, no, I've been stabbed for it.
You fucking. Honestly, sir, deserved. Very much deserved. I just a bit of an English accent. Jesus. What about you?
Oh. I mean, I did it for educational.
No, wait. What of island? What type of island? What part?
You know, I don't remember the town name. You'd have to speak to my father on that. I wasn't there for long enough to. Yeah, yet again, you'd have to speak to my father on that one.
You don't know the county that you are from?
No,
Jesus.
I took a plane as soon as I could walk.
Fucking Christ.
Figure that.
Is that just no? You definitely, I'm not gonna lie to you.
It's
you
somewhere,
definitely seem like
it's somewhere on the outskirts of Dublin. That was.
A Wexford boy, eh? Look at you go. You're definitely. I was gonna say, you're more like I can't remember the name of it. It's beginning with an M. Hey, you bastard. That's my good hat. Oh, no, my boat, my boat! You never seen anything. You see nothing. You never seen anything. You ain't never seen fucking anything, you bastard. I forgot about that, but that. I bent down to pick up my hat. I realised I've shit the boat, but. Hey, that's a sensitive matter. That's a sensitive matter right there. You have no desire. You have no right. No right to doing that. You fucking prick. You fucking little prick.
I need to English, take you made fun of
you
me.
English. You English Irish prick. Fucking hell.
I think
that's a sentence. That's
me.
A death sentence right there. Being
whoa.
English and Irish at the same time. Just
Whoa! Keep it down a notch.
I was in my head figuring out a custom telegram.
No, you did it again. No, you fucking son of a bitch.
It's fine.
And he just fucking yelled out. Oh my.
You should see him with his hat off. Oh my god, his head looks weird.
Oh my god. I just heard him say, "Oh no, my balls."
Look at him when he stands up. Look at his head. You can see an egg underneath his toupee.
Stand up, mister.
Stand up, it's a doctor's order.
Stand up for,
it's a doctor's order. Get up.
Yes, doctor's order.
My
doctor's
god, you can order. See it from here. You can see it from here.
Can I?
Look at his egg.
From which direction do I have
to
look?
Oh, look.
Jesus. Sweet fucking Jesus. Fucking me. Jesus made a face and moves before my fuck.
Stop blaspheming.
You bastard.
Whoa.
Stop blaspheming.
Go on, let me give you a kiss. Oh, no,
I
kiss. That glass.
Honestly, I feel like a giant right now.
Hey.
Hey, listen, we can make fun of each other for our height and our gingerness and our poor eyesight and our horrible size of
hairstyle. I'll claim you like
style,
a fucking beanstalk,
but you can't.
Right?
Exactly. Okay. I'll use you like a cat fucking jungle gym and claw your fucking eyes out, son, okay?
I'm sorry, let me get down so I can hear what you're saying. Say it again.
They're like the same height as us.
make fun of our height.
Yeah, only just taller than you.
Fucking
I'm sorry,
day.
I couldn't help it.
Call me a midget!
You're a midget.
Well, you can at least do it, because you're fucking smaller than me.
I'm taller than you, what do you mean?
No, you not! Look at you! Get your hat! No, I don't want to take my hat off.
Take your hat off, come on.
You take your hat off, I'll take mine. You've got long hair. Your hair kind of poofs up a little bit.
Look,
know?
I'm bony.
I'll even take my shoes off.
Big fucking giant.
Nah, I'm taller. I'm very taller.
I'm still taller and my shoes are not on.
Bro, I feel like Fast and Fury right now.
Yeah, he is a little bit taller, maybe
Mr.
like an
Bald
inch.
Spot,
Sorry, I didn't mean to do that.
No, I would say I'm taller. I'm taller, right?
Mr. Bald Spot.
Mm-hmm.
I'm 185.
What's your last name?
It's Robert.
Robert.
Guama.
Robertson.
G-A-R-M-A.
What? You from Guama?
No, my last name is Guama.
You're from Guama?
Hold him back.
You're from Guama.
What's wrong with this
guy? And what's your first name again?
Tell me who you are. Are you with the people in the pink? Are you
the people in the pink?
Yeah, go on, man. You can go on up here. Luna, I think we need a
psychiatric evaluation on this tournament.
Oh, I'm not certified for that.
Well, then, can we get him locked up in an asylum until he can get one?
Ooh. I have to ask for management.
My bed's warm. I don't want to go English.
Oh, sorry. I didn't even hit you.
Sorry.
What the fuck?
Whoa. Let's knock it out. Let's take a step back.
Wait, let's help this guy. Let's
resuscitate
him.
I'm trying
to pick him up.
Shoo!
I don't
wanna
go.
Back off of the tiny people.
Mommy, go make me some milk and cookies.
Okay. No, that's not gonna work. I'll I'll just push them slowly to the river, it's fine.
Yeah, do that, do that. Just dispose of his corpse.
Howdy!
How's it going, we see her?
Frankie!
Nobody knows me like this today?
Doesn't
that just look different or something?
Oh, no, I haven't seen you for a while, I'm sorry. Were you looking for Miles?
No, I was looking for Hal, so I'm trying to see who he's at.
He just went to take a nap for about an hour, maybe two.
Alright.
Anything I can help you with?
Oh, fuck me.
No, I was looking for Hal, I had to talk to him about something.
You alright, Dad, Nespa?
Okay. It's so cold!
Me?
It's so cold!
I just think you're alright.
It's so cold!
No, alright.
Good. Oh my gosh. Look at this.
Client, I can see your bare ass forehead through your hand. Did I say forehead? I mean 8 head. Jesus Christ.
Balloon, I just seen
Yo,
you yesterday
you
with Miles, alright?
Mm-hmm.
How do I make money?
Yeah.
I work for the government.
Right. Oh wait, are you a deputy?
No,
are
I'm
you,
a defense attorney.
Officer.
I'm a
are
lawyer.
You a
I'm
a lawyer.
Lawyer.
How's the doctor
last?
I haven't logged in for. I didn't log in yesterday until Miles kind of got in some tricky business.
I don't need.
You still got still had all the assistants and shit like that, or they all up the train and all that.
What do you mean?
Cause I know for I heard you had like fucking. Like 15 assistants the one day or something like that.
Oh, no. The max I ever had was 8. But no. It's after
I'm
a lot of my assistants passed and turned into doctors, there's a lot of coverage. It's very nice.
I am. We need a check.
That's good. What about Russell? How's he doing? He passed?
He has not passed yet.
Okay, he just don't be awake or something like that?
Yeah, I think it's something like that.
I'm taller than you.
Nope, you're smaller.
Why do you need him?
Listen, you can beat me on anything else, okay, but not this one.
Say what?
Do you need him?
No. I just know he was going to be a doctor, and I was wondering how he was going. I haven't seen him in a while. Ever since you told me to ask him if he was single, I haven't seen him since then.
Okay.
I want people to have kids now.
So damn bored. There's nothing to
do
right now.
There's lots to do.
Is that a promise?
You could go hunting.
Sure, let me
could
think
go
about using
mining.
The restroom.
There's so many options.
There is, but it's not like the options I want to do. I'm tired of hunting. Hunting and farming, that shit, you know. I'm over all that. All that is outdoing the.
Sticks
and stones may break my bones. It's only fun when my people around me to do something. Everybody's sleeping and shit.
I don't know what came over me.
I hear you. Miles ended up giving love advice to what's her name? Sherry? Sherry?
Did he? What he say to her?
We mostly talked about you.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Something. We can talk somewhere else if you want.
Yeah, I want to know what he said.
Hey, where should we go?
The talking rock right there, the big ass rock.
Scared of the horse.
That's why I'm going on the rock. That horse kicked me, it's a GG's.
Okay, it was something, I wasn't there for the start, so I don't know how it ended up there, but it's something about whenever Sherry is very nice to people, you kind of get a little pissy.
No, so she could be nice, that's cool, I'm cool, you know, people being nice, but then it's like, I don't know, you know how, alright, say you're nice to somebody, but then you're extra nice to Miles because Miles is yours, you know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
I get that vibe sometimes that she's a little extra nice to certain people, and I don't like that. That's what bothers me. See, me, I'm not used to, like, that whole friendly shit like that. I'm used to, like, women I deal with, they're all, like, not really so friendly. No, so I'm not used to how Cherry is. She's real friendly, which is fine and all that. I got used to it, but you know, sometimes I get a vibe she's being extra friendly to somebody, and so she says she don't realize it, but I don't know. But so yeah, speak my mind on it.
Yeah, we ended up having a big discussion because Miles is having the same issue. I don't think he feels like I'm being extra kind to some people, but nonetheless, a lot of the issues are that a lot of us are being seen as flirty just because we're nice, and we're not trying to be flirty.
Yeah, and I think it is, so like you said, it, you know, you could tell when a dude comes up to you and tries to flirt with you or whatnot like that, but you know you guys are nice, you don't try to be mean, but you don't, so it's like entertaining, I guess, you know, somebody's trying to flirt with you, but you're not flirting back, but you're still being nice, you know what I mean? We see it as like, okay, they're entertaining this shit, instead of saying, okay, well, I don't like, you know, you're flirting with me and shit. That's just what I'm used to, so it's like a change from, you know what I mean? Which, like I said, there's nothing wrong about being nice and friendly and shit like that. That's all cool. It's just a change for me. But how we see it is at times, if somebody's flirting with you, we see it, and you guys, like, you know, like, still be nice to them and shit like that. It's us feeling like you guys are entertaining it. But, I mean, you guys are looking at it a whole lot differently. It's just a guy thing. We get jealous.
Don't get me wrong. We get jealous, too, because we ended up having a big discussion about there's this chick who constantly sends Miles telegrams, and she's flirting with him, and he knows that he's flirting with her. And the difference is, he knows, but he's not shutting it down. He just knows she doesn't have a chance. But if me or Cherry did it, you know, you guys would have been all up in our business, being like, why are you not pushing him away? Why are you not spitting in his face?
Yeah, I can see. Yeah. It's like, I see how that could be a thing.
Yeah, and Miles came up with this thing that men would go alpha on alpha to push each other away just as a test to see, hey, am I better than you? So I'm gonna see if I can take your woman. Where in his defense, girls didn't do that, but girls do that. Like,
I
that's
think
not
girls
true.
Do that.
They do.
I think girls do that definitely.
Yes.
Just like I know, like some, like so. Some girls, sometimes you guys, let's be honest here, sometimes you lock their attention. Even though you guys know it's not going nowhere, you just lock their attention at times.
I don't like when flirt with me, because I find it awkward, honestly.
I've got a bit more insight on those people.
Well, so yeah, that could be too, but I feel like girls do get the same way when they feel like, girls do get the same way. Girls do really... feel like, yeah, let me see if I could take her man or something like that, you know?
And they do. Other times they're like, oh, wow, she's not good enough. I can take him. Like, girls, when they find somebody they like, they will go straight to them.
He's a versatrist.
If anything, they're more aggressive that way than dudes. I'm not gonna lie.
They are. And they will, like, dudes will, like, flirt, be like, hey, beautiful. Where a girl will be like, hey, let me flash my tits to you. You
well,
get it?
Hey, beautiful, how you doing?
What the fuck have I witnessed? I was walking past innocently and I hear, hey, can I flash my tits at you? What the fuck did I just hear?
No, we're talking about how girls and boys flirt. Like, girls are a lot more aggressive than guys. Just might not see it, because girls will be like, hey, I'm going to show you my tits. Notice me, senpai, and a guy will be like, hey.
Sorry, what did I just fucking hear?
Yeah, that's what I said. That's what I said when I walked over. I was like, what the fuck?
Okay, what? Let me try saying
you're
it again.
You're like an audience now.
Yeah, he's got a whole audience.
Preach.
Okay.
Preach.
Okay,
okay. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And
No. It's just when girls flirt with a guy and she's like, you know what, I want that guy, he's gonna be mine, then girls will be like, hey, I'm gonna show you my tits to get the attention of the guy. And with guys, it's gonna be like, hey, beautiful, I saw this rose, it reminded me of you. And that would be like the flirtation of guys. It's not gonna
so
be like, hey, look at my dick.
Men try too hard, but they are very romantic, whereas girls just want stuff.
Yes, girls want it, and they will
so
be aggressive about it.
Me is the next time
girls
I have to ask a girl out, I should pull up my
so
dick and go, hey, you come here.
you're telling me that if I show Leopold my boobies, he will actually give me attention?
Mr. Robertson.
Yes, the chances are high.
Oh my god. I think this is it. I'm just saying, I think this is what I have to do.
With most guards in this county, all you have to do is breathe in their direction, they fall for you. Like, it ain't really hard, I've seen it.
Wait, what? With girls? Like, you just breathe in
them? No. Like, some girls, they just have to breathe in a guard's direction, they fall for them.
That is true.
It ain't hard. Like, most guards in here are SIMPs most of the time.
No, listen, Miles tells me that too, and I don't see it, because... Cherry told me no, because Cherry told me about some guy who where she shot a bear and a guy walked up to her and were like, "Hey, that was my bear," and then he continued to follow her, talk with her, like ask about her day, and then I came up with something because I told him I was out hunting in tall trees and this guy comes over to me and says, "Hey, that was my prey. I'm hunting here," and I said, "Okay, I'm sorry. I'm just gonna get this and I'm gonna walk away." And then I skinned the bear, and he shot me. He fucking shot me.
Well, that seems a bit aggressive. But
that
not,
is
said,
so
aggressive. I'm not saying all men.
No, but you see, either is just because I'm not as pretty as Jerry, but still.
See from,
what?
From,
no, of course you're lovable.
So he shot you basically over
$20.
Yes.
Why am I still single?
He's down by it.
Because you have poor taste in women, my friend.
Holy
shit. I've never been with a woman.
Wait,
well,
Teddy,
we
issue,
need to
then.
Find
you
a girlfriend.
You actually made
and
the effort
to
get a
Jeffy,
girlfriend.
We're not going
to
be able to, Teddy.
Jesus Christ.
We're not going to be able to do the thing we're going to do because I've been given a lawful order to leave town. Because a doctor said I was harassing them because I said hello to them. So I'm fucking, I'm done. I've been shot at for doing bullshit.
Which
I've had
doctor
fucking,
said that?
I don't know. See what we were, I don't know. I fucking give up. I'm done. I'm fucking.
Okay, how recent did the complaint come from? Because he's been with me ever since you guys came back into
town.
Yeah,
that's what I mean.
Wow, well, it got quiet for once.
He's literally been at the blacksmith since you guys
left.
Long. He's not left the blacksmith.
Teddy, come with me and explain to you.
I do. Rand, Clyde, can I give him my telegram?
But it's true. Girls are a little bit more aggressive when it comes to that.
Exactly, and it's so annoying because as a girl, when you see like a girl flirting with your man, she's going
to
be sneaky about it, where a man is just going to walk up to you, and he's going to flirt with you straight in front of the other guy. But the girl won't, so unless you tell us, we won't even notice. And you can get close to another girl without even us noticing, and that is actually more upsetting. And that is why most girls are kind of aggressive towards other girls when they feel a connection.
Wait, repeat that? There's so many people talking.
Okay, I can try. When, you know, when girls flirt and want something, mm-hmm. they're gonna do it, like, behind the other girl's back. But a guy will go alpha and be like, "Hey, let me prove to you that I can steal your woman." So he's gonna walk up in front of her and the boyfriend.
Like that.
Yes,
yeah, guys like that. I
but girls.
I hate those kind of men.
Yes, but girls don't do it, and that's why it's so hard for girls to like. We're seeing, oh, you're just emotional. Oh, you're so jealous because there's no proof. We can prove it because that chick is sending you little love letters at
mm-hmm.
night, and you're hiding them under your pillow. And I haven't checked under your pillow.
Well,
you get it?
if they're doing that, like the person who you're dating at the time ain't worth spit. Like, if you have a partner that is doing that behind your back, you shouldn't even be with them in the get-go, right? You shouldn't
exactly.
even worry about your partner about having to do all that. Otherwise, like, if I ever had a concern and my partner was being shady about it, I would just drop him right there and then.
See, I don't know if I would. I know that Miles is getting telegrams from this fucking lady, but he's been
mm-hmm.
telling me about it every time, and now I know that he knows that she's flirting with him, but he's not telling her no. Like, he's not telling her, "Yo, girl, back off." She knows he has a fiance, but he's
what?
Not backing
hey,
off.
Hey, uncle. Been a few days. How you doing?
What the fuck are you wearing?
That's a strawberry uniform.
That is a part-time job.
Right, I'm back.
Howdy.
Howdy.
I said part-time. What? It's a part-time job.
Oh, did he tell you that he broke his leg today? Where
wait, did you use the sprint splint when you
now.
Did?
Oh yeah, no, I had crutches.
Oh yeah, crutches. Oh shit.
Next time, can you break your neck?
Holy
it's
shit!
What?
You know what? You know what? You little goblin man. I've actually not missed you whatsoever anymore. Fuck you.
Wait, I want to hear this impression, Alexander.
Yeah, what's this fucking impression of me, huh?
What impression?
Go on, no, go on, fucking funny fuck, go on, funny fuck, say it.
Okay,
do it.
But at least Miles lets you know.
Oh gosh, I'm going to give fucking $3,000 to
okay, let's go,
family.
Wait, come on.
I'm so rich. Oh gosh, look at my
Doesn't she let you know?
But she's like, it's, So there's a thing where some dude was flirting with her, and I told her, I was like, he basically wants you and shit like that. And she's like, well, I didn't take it that way. I'm like, bullshit. If I notice it, I know you notice. He's talking about, oh, I can show you my gentle side, show you a few places that I know that are nice little spots, you know, show you how gentle I am and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah, that's definitely, even I would have noticed that.
Yeah, she's like, well, I didn't take it as him trying to go on a date with me or something. That's exactly what he's trying to do. That is exactly what he's trying to do. And then, like, it's just, like, little shit I was, I don't get this feeling for no reason, you know what I mean? Like, I always trust my gut. I learned something like that. Mm. And then, come to find out, she said, yeah, you know, you was a talking to me for a little bit, and I did entertain him a little bit, get you jealous. I don't like shit like that. So she already, but she was like, oh, well, I don't think that he was trying to take me on a date or such and such. I was like, well, if I know it, then everybody, you fucking had to know it. You're just trying to play dumb, it seems like. I don't know, maybe I just got a little bit of trust issues and shit like that.
Okay, can I ask you a weird question? The issue has already been resolved, but I want to know your feelings about it. Let's say you and I, you're Miles now, and you're having your feelings. I have Leopold as one of my best friends in the whole freaking world. And we have this common joke where I have been drinking gin, and I have a very hard time drinking it like without anything mixed into it, and then me and him talked about it. Oh, you just gotta open your throat and swallow it. And then I said I don't know how to swallow, and everyone heard me, and it became a whole joke and everything. Yesterday Leopold said it, and I said, yeah, we gotta have one of those times where you teach me how to swallow again. And Miles got like pissed about it, but he knows the whole story. He knows that it's just, you know, it's seen as perverted, but it's not meant as perverted. Would you have been upset with that too?
Maybe a little bit, but if I know that it wasn't intended for it to be like, you know, like you are doing something, then no. But if it's like a little joke, maybe I'd be like, whoa, that joke came out of left field, you know what I mean? Like, I would probably say something to you, but you know, I mean, it was like you said, it was a perverted joke, but it wasn't meant to be perverted in that way. It was just like one of those little jokes.
Yeah, and you know the story. You know that it's just about alcohol, you know, stuff like that.
Yeah, but like I said, yeah, if I would have heard it, if I was Miles, it would have caught me a little bit off guard, like, what the fuck? Like, I would have said something like that, but that was about it.
But
especially if it's somebody you know, I know you're good friends with already, I know there's nothing there going on, I wouldn't be really too worried about it.
Yeah, but you're also good friends with him. It would be like if you and I were together and Miles had said it, and you knew this intern joke with me and him, and the joke is even before we got to know each other and we're a couple, so it's like a joke that has been there for years.
Yeah, so that basically, with that joke being there for years, means that you guys been friends for years, and that was already understanding that you guys are not just friends, you know what I mean?
And he's engaged, and I'm engaged, you know? So we're both, like, not single. So would you still have been? Plus, the whole build-up was also them talking about standing in a circle, jerking each other off. So you see the jokes are kind of perverted with Leopold, so would you still have been super mad about it?
No, like I said, I wouldn't have been super mad. I would just been like, hey, what the fuck? Like, that came out of nowhere. I would probably laugh it off, though, because, you know, it's like a reaction for someone to get mad about certain, but then it would have sunk in, like, okay, well, that is her friend and all that. I know that there's no harm. It's just a little perverted joke. I mean, like you said, he was already in a circle making jokes like that and shit like that. It's no different. But if it was like, it's somebody, like you said, is a good friend, he's married, I mean, he's engaged, you're engaged, it's not like it's an outsider and you said it too, you know what I mean?
Exactly, and he said it in front of you and everyone else, and they all already talked about, you know, sleeping with each other and leaving me out of it, you know? The jokes are just perverted when it's that group, so it's kind of, I would feel like it wouldn't be unexpected, if you get it?
Yeah, I see what you're saying. Yeah, I wouldn't be upset about that, but yeah, maybe Miles took it, like, he, I don't know. Has he ever felt the way with you two guys before? Like, you and, was it Leopold, you said?
Yeah, it was Leopold who made the comment, and I continued the joke. So he started, but I kind of entertained it, you know?
Yeah. I mean, he never had a suspicion for you guys before, right? He's always knew you guys were just friends, right?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, then I don't really see no problem. Like I said, it probably been like a what the fuck, like it just caught you by surprise type of thing, but you know, that's about it.
Yeah, because we got in like a crazy big argument, so big that Miles, like he got really hurt and he refused for me to treat him, and he ended up like having super low vitals and we had to wait for a doctor, and like he lost a lot of blood and shit, but he refused for me to treat him. Like, he was ready to die.
Yeah, us men get like that. So there was a situation where Cherry said something and I fell down a cliff and my leg was broken and I refused to get on a horse. We're just hard-headed like that. It just means we're a little bit bothered. We're a little upset.
Yeah, but you know what? His leg was broken too. And everything was just bleeding and everything. And he refused to get on my horse and I got upset. Because, you know, I am a doctor and you're refusing for me to treat you, and I can respect that, but when you're low vitals and everything, it's just... You're willing to die over you being pissed about something that was just a fucking joke?
Yeah, like I said, we're hard-headed, and I'm sure he realized it right after.
Oh, he didn't. Sure. He didn't. We ended up having, like, a big argument on an island, and the boat disappeared, so he couldn't even run away when I got super pissed about it. But in the end, I think he understood my point and he kind of took all of the blame and apologized. But I just wanted to know, because sometimes you need to know if I maybe just pushed him into a corner where he felt like he had to apologize. You know? You get it?
No. See, when we're hard-headed, well, I can say for myself, when I'm hard-headed, it's because, you know, it's a pride thing. Like, we already want to apologize and all that and shit like that. But, you know, our pride gets in the way and we just don't want to do it. What we should do, so we let it build up for a while too. Like, okay, this is enough, it's time to apologize and set things right, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
it's a guy thing.
Yeah, but Miles said something that there was it was a build up of many things, and I asked what, and he said, oh, it was the guy in the gunsmith, and I got annoyed by that, because I asked him, okay, what was with the guy? Was it when the guy hit me and I beat him up and they then gave him medical treatment, and then he hit me again, and Cherry came in and said, don't fucking hit Luna. So she beat him up, and he needed medical treatment, and then he came in again, and then he hit me again, and Miles chased him. Like, I don't know, was my fault being assaulted? Because I don't know where the whole issue was at that point. And he couldn't even explain it. He just said, stop, stop, stop. Let's just put it down. That's my best Miles impression. I'm sorry.
I don't know. And maybe you just mad at the dude assaulted you and kept trying to do it or something like that. Was he like, was he doing like a playful manner or something like that?
I don't know. He kept annoying because it was me, Leopold, Heather. I think Jack House was there too. And he kept walking in and pushing us all aside and interrupting conversations. And Leopold said, wow, this guy is so annoying. So I told him to go away. So he hit me once and said, bitch, don't talk to me. And then I hit him and was like, don't speak to me like that and get the fuck out of here. And then he started hitting me and I just ended up, you know, beating him to the ground and then gave him medical attention and told him to fuck all her off. And then
maybe that dude pissed him off. It wasn't anything you did. I think it was just that dude pissed him off.
But does that imply, because he was already pissed off, does that imply that it would continue because he's already pissed off, then it kind of ends up going on me, or...
Sometimes that happens. Sometimes you can be pissed off with something previously that happened, and then, you know, then something happens with you too, and it just adds on to him being pissed off, and it kind of gets lost. Like, all that pissed offness, it's just like gets directed towards something that it shouldn't get directed to. You know what I mean? So, So it probably had bits and pieces to do with you, and I know it probably had a lot to do with that incident with that dude at the gunsmith, but it all just, like, you know, went to you. It's like, you ever heard the saying, I'm not your punching bag, or something like that?
Yeah.
It's like a... Sometimes it happens. We all do it. Sometimes we get mad about one situation and somebody else pisses us off, and it's like everything all together that pisses off just gets directed towards that person because they're right there in the line of fire. We really don't mean to do it. It just happens. So like I said, the pride got in the way and he knew that, so that's why he apologized to you and all that.
Yeah, okay. Because I think you and Miles kind of have the same mindset, so like, Loki wanted to see, because it's easier for you to explain than for Miles, because Miles puts in a lot of emotions and he might sugarcoat it to not make me upset, so it's better, you know, sometimes to ask for somebody neutral.
Yeah. Me and my, I kind of think that too. Miles kind of think alike a little bit, but yeah, I think that's all what it is you know, the pride thing. When we get mad, we don't like to admit we're wrong or we're, you know, something's bothering us and shit like that. That's the thing too. If something's bothering us, you'd be like, you got, you're at, we'd be like, yeah, we're all right, we're smooth, but we don't say nothing, and you know, we won't show that we're bothered until we keep thinking about it, and it really pisses us off, and then we just like show it without trying to show it. That's what happens too.
I think girls do that too, end up building it up, but we write it down, and then when we fight, we will bring it all up to you.
Oh yeah, you gotta save it for ammo. You just be waiting for that. It stays yes. Like right in the gun belt, just waiting for that.
Yeah, I try not to do it, cause Miles, he's been joking a lot about it. Whenever I upset him or do something that he doesn't agree with, he's like, oh, it seems like Luna's gonna enjoy single life. And I ended up grabbing him and said, hey, I know it's just a joke, or at least I fucking think so, but I don't appreciate it because I'm unsure how to take it. Like, are you being sweet and trying to break up with me in a cute way? Or are you being, like, joking about actually breaking up with me? I don't know how to take it. So I wanted him to stop. And then with the Leopold comment, he ended up saying it again. And I asked him, are you fucking serious? And he said, yes, I'm fucking serious.
Yeah, that sounds like something else is going on. You probably gotta have a real sit down with him.
Oh, we did. But
Oh, you did. Yeah, you said yeah. You got had a little argument and shit like that.
Yeah, that was the whole argument, and I got pissed with him, and then he got pissed at me because I was pissed with him about doing it. And he doesn't like when I give him attitude, because when I get pissed, I'm just like, sure.
Know what it might be?
What?
How you be working at the blacksmith a lot? You be at, you know, being a doctor a lot. Maybe just one day you guys just need to take a day for you guys. You know what I mean?
That was yesterday. We took a whole day just for the two of us, and then we started fighting.
Holy shit. Damn.
And I'm getting a little bit of issues because whenever we have a big fight and I get really upset with me, he's gonna be like, Luna, just so you know, like, I love you so, so much, and I appreciate you. And I feel like he's trying to be like, look at me sugarcoating you. Look at me putting you in a warm blanket before I punch you in the face.
No, I think he does love you. I think he really does. It's like I said, we get bothered at times. As men, we get bothered at times, and we just, you know, it's a pride thing that comes in a way where we're getting bothered. We feel like, you know, if we show that we're bothered most of the time, we're looked at like we're soft or something like that.
I get it, but why? What? You need to stop. You need guy talk. You need to sit down with guys and be like, you know what?
I love how you just point it and then clap right after. You need guy talk and then start clapping.
Just get what I say. Get what I'm saying, okay?
I get what you're saying. Me and Miles will talk one day. If he comes around today, I'll you know, we'll go out about and talk. Because the same way he's probably with you is the same way I'm with Cherry.
Exactly, because I found out yesterday when Jerry and him were speaking, and I kind of just walked into this conversation, and I was backing her up, and she was backing me up.
Look at fucking Lloyd just ate shit over there.
Get ready.
Yeah, and I'm sorry.
But I don't think he's going to be awake today, but I think maybe all of us should, like, hang out and have, like, a heartfelt conversation, all of us.
Maybe. We just might have to.
Without a gunfight? What the fuck happened when Miles got shot? Because he refused to tell me.
It was some shitters acting up that, you know, decided to start trying to shoot at us and shit like that, so we had to shoot back.
In Tall Trees? Was it the... Because I know there's a tribe over there being very aggressive.
No, it wasn't the tribe. It was some fucking... I don't know what the fuck they're called. I don't know who the fuck they were. We was going on our way and shit like that, and them guys start talking their shit. As we're going past, so they had to get dealt real quick. But Miles, you know, got hit. But luckily, we ran into you because he was really bleeding. I had his blood on my back like all fucking day yesterday. I changed clothes and everything. It was just like, boom, still on you. Go wash, you know, go wash yourself off or something.
Yeah, it was chaotic when you came because I tripped and I twisted both my ankles, so I couldn't run. It was very chaotic.
Oh, we just caught you at the perfect time then. That's yes. What that was.
I was on my way to Blackwater to get treated myself.
Yeah, we caught you at the perfect time. Two injured people going to Blackwater. One shot, other one's ankle fucked up.
Yeah, I ended up him. It was so dusty there. All of the doctors couldn't see me, but I could see Miles. So I just treated Miles, and then I had to, like, figure out a way for me to get treated.
Ooh, did you have to take a nap?
No, that didn't help. So we ended up going all the way to Armadillo. Miles could talk with the doctor, so he was like, okay, let's meet in Armadillo and let's treat Luna there. And then out of nowhere, Miles disappeared from me, so I had to walk on my stumpy little legs all the way to Armadillo.
Yeah, that happened to Miles Day too, and then out of nowhere in the saloon, he disappeared. Well, I didn't even see him. Then, you know, he gets on the piano, it's a fucking shirtless dude playing the piano. I'm like, what the fuck? Shirtless dude with suspenders on. I was like, yeah, that's fucking Miles.
Yeah, of course.
But he... Yeah. Hmm? What were you gonna say?
I was gonna ask if you and Cherry are okay.
We're alright. She kind of did some shit yesterday, kind of pissed me off a little bit. It had nothing to do with, like, fucking, like, relationship-wise or anything. It was, like, on the other part of, like, family shit. Kind of did something that could have ended bad for everybody. So, you know, I had to talk to her about that and kind of, you know, rubbed me the wrong way. But I got to know, I got to learn that she's new to, like, being in the family and all that, like, the lifestyle of it and all that. So I got to learn not to be so hard on her. But at the same time, I mean, that's how I learned. I'm just a hard person at times.
Yeah, I feel like she would kind of understand better with a sweet tone.
Well, I see, I try to be nice. Like, I have patience. I'll talk and I'll tell her something. The conversation go on for 30 minutes, go for fucking here, there, to everywhere. Just to get back to that same question that she had in the beginning that I answered already. Just to go back to the second question. Third, it's just like a talking in the circle. And that's what kind of bothers me at times. I'm like, well, goddamn, I explained all this already. Like, I don't know. I guess it's like a reassurance thing or something. I don't know.
It is also sometimes because Miles does it every time. Like, if I ask him, like, hey, what do you want to eat today? And he's like, oh, I could really eat something with, like, a wheat in it, or, like, potatoes, or maybe I could eat that, or maybe we could go out in the forest and go hunting. We could probably find something. We could also go to Saint Denis and stuff, and then I still haven't gotten an answer. And then he gets pissy at me for asking, so what do you want to eat? Like, we already covered this. We could go hunting. We could go do this. We could go farming. Doesn't answer my question.
Yeah, it's like he gave you all these other different things instead of, I get it.
Yeah, I think maybe, you know, sometimes Daisy understands it like that too. Or not Daisy, I'm sorry, Cherry. Jesus fucking Christ, I don't know why I want to call her Daisy.
Sometimes she does, but then sometimes, like, I'll give her the exact answer and she'll act like she didn't hear it. So she'd be really needing a lot of reassurance. I don't know, I'm not good at, like, I told her since day one, I'm not good at, you know, this relationship, emotional shit and all that. I don't show, like, my soft side so much.
Mm.
It's, like, just because the shit that happened in the past with me, you know. I mean, it's not her fault, and I tried to tell her that. I said, it's not your fault, but it's not something I can control.
Mm.
Something I could work on, try to get better at it, but it's not, like, something I can control at this point, just how I am.
Mm.
If that makes sense.
Yeah, that makes sense, that makes sense. But, you know, everyone always needs to work a little bit on the relationship. And I tried to tell Miles that because he didn't. He was like, okay, I own up to all of it. And I was like, no, you need to explain to me right away what the big issues are. Because you said that it was building up. And if I don't know why it was building up, I can't change it. Oh, but it's nothing you can change. Yeah, you say that now. And then it builds up again. Like, you understand, right? You need to know what the problems are. Otherwise, it can't be fixed.
Just so, you know, you can avoid it happening again and shit like that.
Exactly. And if it's like, oh, you're just being too nice to people, then I need to work on it and try to be a little less nice. Maybe, you know, I don't want to be less nice, but, you know, sometimes sacrifices must be made.
Yeah, well, I know he's going to see that it's, you know, you're trying to, and that's what matters to. He'll see that you're trying and all that, you know, everything be all right. It's like you said. Sometimes men just need a man-to-man talk about something. It could be something that you're telling him, and I go talk to him about the same shit he'll understand. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's weird like that.
Sometimes it's just better when another gender, you know, the same gender kind of tells you the same things.
Because the same thing with me and Cherry. When he sees I'm having a hard time with Cherry, he'll tell me something that she told me, and I don't listen to her, but I'll listen to him. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's just one of those things.
But I think that is where the emotions comes in, because the reason might be because you have emotion involved, where when a smile is coming up, it's more like a friend to friend, and not
yeah,
a,
that's exactly
you know,
what
just
it is.
Annoying me.
Now that you put it that way, that's exactly what it's like, a friend, you know, someone I feel like I can say something to and ain't gonna look at me no different way, which, you know, you women ain't gonna look at us no way either, but we just still, you know, feel like we gotta have that tough guy act and shit like that, you know what I mean?
But the difference is, like, right now, if I told you this and you said, wow, Luna, you're kind of a bitch, if Miles did that, I would slap him. But with you, I would be like, wow, that's very harsh, why do you call me that? And you would have the ability to, like, explain it to me, where with Miles, I would just get upset and start yelling. You get it?
Yeah, I get that.
Because the relationship is different.
Exactly. So this is weird how this shit works, but yeah. Maybe we all get together one day and I'll do something. Who knows? Oh, fucking, I think tomorrow they're having a grand opening that road. Try to get Miles and fucking Cherry and everybody to go down there. They're going to have alcohol and all that.
That could be nice, depending on what time, because I'm not gonna be there for too much tomorrow.
I don't know what time it is. I know Skelly was telling me something, but I got to check up with him again.
Well, if you end up seeing Miles or anything, you could probably tell him, or
he might tell me.
I don't know if I meet him. I tend to meet him, but I don't know.
We always know where to find him. His ass right there at the fucking blacksmith. I guarantee it's hard for him to find you because you're a doctor. You gotta go here, there, everywhere.
Yeah, but I try to tuck in and be where he is, kind of.
Yeah. Which is strawberry.
Which is strawberry. Unless they need a lot of ore, then I plug in under New Austin and then I just go mining.
Wait, so doctors can, they're not just set for one person, so you could be over there by ESO and all that?
Strawberry, yeah. If we clock in, we just have to go to all of the calls. We don't have to stand by the doctor's office unless we're clocked in under, like, strawberry. And only strawberry. Then we should be in the strawberry area.
Okay.
Where with law, they just kind of stand around. Doctors normally don't do it. Some do. But normally, I don't like standing around for too long.
So, are you able to get... know when people are down and shit like that? Now I know it was a problem before.
We are now, the local doctors and the locals are getting more friendly with us, so now they don't mind speaking with us. So they walk up and tell us stuff.
They just had to get used to you guys and shit like that at first.
Yeah.
I see that.
Have you never been down?
Me?
Yeah.
Yeah, I was. You treated me the one time.
Oh, right.
And I had the graze on my head in fucking Mexico.
Right. Oh, that's true. Yeah, that was sick.
That was just about it. Well, them shitters deserve that. I know that much.
I don't know them. I don't want to get into it.
No, well, that me neither. That's all I'm going to say is they just deserved it. That's all. That's just that.
Yes. Okay.
That's just that, but I think I'm going to take a nap for a little bit.
Sleep tight.
All right, thank you. I'll see you around then, Luna. Nice talking to you.
Of course. Nice talking to you, too. Boop.
All right. And this is where we take the awkward walk in the same fucking direction.
Sorry.
No, it's all right.
Good evening, Miss Luna.
Good evening. Hello. Is this just a gathering of doctors?
It seems like it. Me and Eleanor here covering Strawberry to Little Creek.
Hello.
I believe Sebastian is covering, or at least he was covering Blackwater. I'd have to check in and make sure he's still around. Looks like he's still around.
If killing you lot is what it takes.
Goodness gracious.
The graves will fight and bleed for true love. To see it blossom on the fields.
Lies.
Of Blackwater Range.
Ah, he's a poet.
Liar!
I'm not a liar, Luna.
Liar!
Hello, doctors. How are we?
The DB needs stitches.
Hello.
You alright?
Hello. Yeah, we're here.
I don't know, am I?
Marie and Clad are getting married.
Or are you all left?
What?
Alright, you keep going now.
Luna, I need your help.
What the fuck?
Say Dr. Finch.
Well, fuck, what's happening?
Can you correct your sister?
She's
got these ridiculous notions that she and Clyde are gonna get together.
Oh.
Can you correct her?
Yes, you have to wear white. That is a red outfit, so you have to wear white. And it should probably be a skirt. But it is a little chilly, so I would wait for it to not snow.
Luna's on Team Maria.
Luna.
Yeah.
If you don't
Luna's
help
on
me,
Team Love.
If you don't help me in this cause right now, I will write a citation.
Richard, I
hold
all the
aces. Which will get you removed from the doctor's office.
Listen, I don't get this. I'm correcting her. She can't wear that outfit.
I like it.
What if I just show up in a wedding dress? Like, just go make one right now and come back out. I think you need a lawyer.
I say, do you know technically I could wed you right here?
Let's do it.
Like, get you both married.
Yeah, you could, absolutely.
It needs to be a big special occasion.
Do you, Clyde, take Maria Ray, with the Maria Rose as your lovely wedding wife?
I am not doing it in front of my brother's blacksmith. It needs to be a special occasion. No expenses
spent.
I haven't even been officially proposed to yet, Father. Come on.
Yeah, fucking hell.
Clyde Crane, do you take Maria Rose Cavendish as your lawfully wedded wife?
Yes.
Maria Rose Cavendish, do you take Clyde Crane as your lawfully wedded husband?
Yes.
You may kiss and, I guess.
That was the saddest wedding ceremony ever.
Yeah.
Go on, kiss then. Go on. No balls.
I mean, he's no balls, man, so I've got to now.
If you do, I hope you know it means you're getting married.
No, it doesn't.
It does.
There's no legal documentation at this moment in time.
They have to sign it.
I'm writing it
generally,
right
if you seal
now.
It,
no,
if you seal it
no.
with a kiss, you're legally married.
I genuinely, right now, I'm looking at it right now. If you seal with a kiss right now, I have full proof with witnesses here, and I can sign it off saying that you got married right here, right now.
Look, I'm not having you ruin my wedding plans. I want a big wedding. All the boys there.
That's why I thought, it's a load of bullshit, see?
It's not. It's not bullshit. Don't ruin Maria's wedding when she needs a wedding.
Yeah.
It has to be big and pretty.
It's her wedding first. Jesus.
No, where is your wedding, Luna?
I should correct you. Don't get married before me. I've been engaged longer than you. That's not really fair.
I'm not even been engaged.
I can't wait to get married to my second wife.
Well, your first wife is on Team Clyde, by the way.
Yeah, she is.
We was talking about it yesterday, so
you're
gonna have to.
There we are. So, we do it like this. If you two get married, I will get a second wife.
Is that supposed to upset me?
No.
Is that going to be an issue for them? I think you're going to have the biggest issues with Kitty, honestly. Because let's just... No, not you.
She's not going to stand for that shit.
I can't get more new and improved kids from another wife.
New and improved?
Well,
like,
that's perfect.
Fuck you,
I have got one spare brother, and I think Kitty and Booker would make a beautiful couple.
All the kids would be ginger.
Exactly.
What is this horse doing?
See, I'm gonna plan my second wife then. Yeah, if you're planning your wedding, I'm planning my second
wife. You ain't got
balls
for it anyway. You're not pretty enough to get another one.
Did you say no balls to that?
I definitely said no balls.
No, you did not just say no balls to that.
Luna's out here spitting heat.
Luna, you better retract that because you know how religiously I will do it.
What did she say?
Do not. She said no balls.
Don't do it.
To what?
To my getting a second wife.
Don't
no
do
balls.
It.
Do it, you
no
won't.
Balls.
You don't have the minerals.
I'm retracting my no balls?
No. It's too late. Too late. There's three no balls hit. Right, I'm gonna get everything planned then. Alright.
Can you at least wait until after the posters have been made?
No, I hope you guys know that I'm genuinely gonna do it now.
If you could even get him,
that's all you're gonna do to stop me.
Yeah.
Don't listen to him, he's just trying to distract us.
Can you please
away from
Luna, you're a doctor, sew his mouth shut.
Uh oh. What do you got him tied for?
I'll go do that while you say
that's, oh, that's family. That's her father. Don't worry. That's her father.
Just like we said earlier, if y'all could just please try to keep it down a little bit in town, as much shit's been going on, so kind of on edge. Cheers.
Well, thank God they're on private property.
You hear that, Maria?
Take him inside, close the doors. We didn't see anything.
Maybe lock the doors and turn the lights down.
Sorry, my ears popped as soon as I picked you up. That was so weird.
Maybe lock them doors and turn the lights down low. Put some music on that's soft and slow.
Slow.
I'm getting out of here.
Oh, Pedro! Good to see you again, man.
What the fuck happened to you?
Everything. Remember when it was just me and you alone?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Everything
happened. Nah, I don't know. You told me that.
Do you not know?
No.
I do.
Wills and testaments for $50 for deputies.
What?
Okay, someone cut off one of his toes.
Hey.
I'm not gonna do it.
No balls.
I'll do it. I'll do it.
No balls.
Oh. Sorry?
What is that?
I retract the statement. Yeah, the fucking... Maria, you're not gonna stand there and let that happen. Maria!
You're not planning a second wife, right?
I'm single, don't have family, so...
I'm gonna die.
You're not planning a second wife, right?
No, I am. If you two are doing it, then I am. Good luck.
Get your knife out.
No.
Yeah.
I've removed his boots. I have removed his boots.
Yeah, he's removed my boots.
It was an entire group of them.
Interesting. Who's that? Well, it's Azir.
See? My boots are off.
Take one of the little ones.
Hello.
Oh, we're doing some illegal shit in here, so...
Yeah. Yeah, well, do what?
So please stand outside.
I am going to get three of this because, you know what? Fuck you guys. Fuck you guys. You want to play this game, I'll play it better.
I don't understand your problem.
I don't understand your problem. Yes. All I want is a few wives. I just want two.
You've already gone through several wives.
Alright. Give me several. I've only had one.
Who's got the cactus?
Who's got the cactus? Actually,
or should I just use my gun? It's green.
Trying to think of all the wives. Maybe the head veterinarian. Do you remember the head veterinarian?
Anyone have a flask?
Oh, she's got.
How you doing?
Oh.
Alright, let me just get
I should not leave the two assistants by themselves.
Are we having our last dinner here?
Yeah, I'm just discussing my future wife to be.
Who's your wife to be, Richard?
I'm trying to figure out. Maybe. The DA is rich and famous. Maybe the DA.
She's also taken.
Do you know what I find funny? The second kid wakes up, he's going to be like, oh, he was all a joke, kid.
You think I'm going to be like
that? Yeah, definitely. Whether I'm there or not, I know it's happening.
I think Maria knows how exactly...
They're putting words in my mouth. They're incriminating me.
No, I'm going to tell them it's no balls. The only way this gets solved is you retracting the no balls. You two and Leopold. You are the three that have... Yeah,
well, I didn't know balls.
Why is he blobbing on the fish on the table?
Oh, he's trying to cut a toe off.
Yeah, he's trying to cut off my toes.
Don't cut off his toes. He needs them to walk.
I know.
Just his pinky toes.
Actually, it's alright because if he won't represent you, I probably still will.
Yay.
Yeah. So the only way this gets solved is if you three retract your statements of no balls.
I didn't know balls. Shit.
You did.
No, I didn't.
So do you want me to retract my balls?
No, it's up to you guys. I don't care.
I retract my statement.
No, not you.
Well, I said that I'd do it, you won't.
It's Clyde, so. Maria, and Leopold.
I
to
didn't
say,
no balls shit.
You have to
I don't
say,
use no balls.
Just
you have
just
to say
I retract my statement.
Yeah.
Just say it.
I can't retract a statement I never made.
Just say it, or he's going to be grumpy, and he's going to still do it.
No, I'm not going to be grumpy. I'm gonna
he's
be
like
happy.
A little baby. I can't believe that your two daughters are more adult than you are.
Right?
I can't wait to get another daughter who will be responsible. Actually, no, Luna, you're doing great. Luna, you're great. You're a great daughter.
I don't respect my wife to be like that.
Maria
is also doing great.
She's a snake.
A snake?
How dare you? And why is she a snake? Come with statements. You're a lawyer. Like, stand up for your fucking statement.
He's not a lawyer yet.
See, look what you made me do now. I've got to
he's
go
an elderly filing
go
clerk at the DA's
to be
office.
Wife to be.
Yeah, that's all he is.
I can't wait for my wife to be.
As if you could even get any new wife. Have you seen Richard yourself
just can't
lately?
Wait to be my work wife.
What do you mean? I'm still That's a beautiful man.
You're old and you're great and you're wrinkly. It's going to be very hard for
Decrepit.
You to get another one.
Overweight.
Trust me. Trust me, ladies like the older men.
Bare feet.
Ladies' sex drives gets higher when they get older and men starts getting a harder time getting it up. I don't feel like you're going to be able to satisfy a new lady.
How old are you, Richard?
Old like 100? Your dad.
Yeah, no, but how old are you?
Old enough to be your dad.
Well, my dad's in his 40s, so...
Oh, well, yeah.
You're old enough to be his dad?
No.
Probably.
So you're probably in your 50s?
Yeah.
No.
Okay.
Or 80s?
Well...
Luna, you're making this very difficult.
Which one?
Can someone put my shoes back on? It's fucking freezing.
I think Clyde walked up with them.
I'm gonna get frostbite. I'm gonna lose my toes anyway.
Well, it's not my fault.
I have lost my missus.
You'll be fine though.
Can I have my... Oh, thank you. I got socks on. Can I have my boots back? Clyde. My feet are getting cold.
Are they? Have you...
Yeah.
Have we solved this now?
No.
Not a no.
I can't wait for my second wife.
You're not gonna get a second wife. You can't even get a first one.
Whoa, what do you mean?
Second wife? What did I come back to?
Yes, I'm getting a second wife because Clyde and Maria get married.
You're not fucking marrying Maria. That's fucking sick.
Works. I didn't say that.
Fun fact. You can't be the attorney for your own documents, and I wouldn't sign that, so... Unless
okay,
you want to go
DA
and...
Will. The DA will.
The DA can't do marriage licenses.
Oh, you're shit creek with that
it's okay.
now.
It's okay. Yeah.
Unless you want to associate with the Black Lily one.
Yeah, I'll go to Black Wills.
Because
that's what you
want to
play, Teddy.
The ones that put shit in our mouths.
If you want to play like that, Teddy, I would do anything for the no balls. I am a man of honor, and then when someone says no balls to me, I fulfilled that no balls.
So you're
That's
a man
so
of no
sad.
Balls?
No, I will always have balls because I always fulfill the right to wear balls.
We can change that.
We can circumcise him.
So you'll always.
You realize circumcision and castration are two very
being
different
circumcised
things.
By a French
if we circumcise him, I'll make a machete for it right now,
well,
and it's gonna be my cock
honor
machete.
No balls.
No balls. Sorry, Leo, you just got no balls.
Richard.
What?
Leo, do it.
Will you always honor a no balls?
Yes.
I no balls you to allow me
no,
to marry
no, no, no,
your
no,
daughter.
No, that's not how it works.
Well, no balls.
It's not
no
how
balls.
It works.
No,
no balls.
No, he doesn't have
no
balls.
No balls. How it works is no that balls. You say something, like I'm gonna do something, and then you say no balls to me, and then I have
you're
to
gonna,
do what
you're
I say.
You're going to accept of Clyde's marriage, no balls.
No, no that's balls. No, that's not how it works.
Balls.
That is exactly
balls.
How it works.
Balls.
No,
balls.
No.
Balls.
Look at his chicken.
Balls.
Am I interrupting something?
Are we
yes.
just chanting
no,
balls?
Yeah,
you're releasing me.
We're
kidnapped. Richard,
please. It's not a kidnap, you're an adult.
This is a cult. Okay, adult napping. It's still kidnapping
well,
on the penal code.
Kind of on our
Can I have my
table?
Shoes back now, please? Fucking prick.
Oh,
Jesus.
What the hell? Your boots back, there's your boots. You better clean them up for the wedding.
Yeah. If I get accused for this shooting again, I swear to God.
Right, sorry, what was going on?
Oh, there is a shootout.
Why is there a massive fucking shootout?
Well, I got accused of the last
I
one.
I can't
so.
Hear it.
Two wolves.
Guys, don't fucking run into the shootout, you fucking plebes. Okay. I think it's fine. I think it's just someone testing guns, maybe. Against people, maybe, but... Oh, sorry, what? Oh. Oh.
No, I'm
okay.
here. I'm here.
Oh,
you want to
Joseph. Alright, let's go talking here then.
You confused old man.
Oh, Jesus. You're a confused old fucking goddamn Prussian.
Right, so Leo.
He's just mad.
Is there a shootout?
Yes.
What happened to you, Leopold?
Everything, Luna. Everything.
Someone reported the shootout.
So we were out smelting, Christian, Vanessa, and I, right? My horse disappeared, and while I was finishing up the last bars, Vanessa went out to find a new horse for me to ride back, right?
Leopold,
she was bitten by
will.
A snake. No.
Oh.
She was bitten by a snake. So they had to immediately go to Valentine. I had to run back to Strawberry. I was bitten by a snake. I almost made it to Strawberry when a lawman patrol came. I was like, deputies, help, I'm bitten by a snake. One of them heroically jumped off to give me an elixir. And as I was about to drink the elixir, his horse kicked me in the head.
No.
Sounds like an ish you, not an ish me.
I'm sorry, are you okay?
And then I got like the venom shot, the elixir thingy from the doctor, and he gave me like a nice little bandage with some little cute horses on it.
Aww.
And he gave me some a little sweet because I was so brave.
Aww. So it wasn't a terrible day, that's good, that's good.
Yeah, it was still pretty goddamn awful, but yeah.
Luna, you're a doctor, you want a will?
No.
Why does no one want wills?
Ken is desperate for money right now. He should have learned a proper profession like blacksmithing.
I've made $500 today alone.
That's
I've
good.
Made $4,000 today.
I haven't made any dollars today.
I made 500 and then 400 of that went to buying my horse, which is now somewhat running off.
That was mean, stupid
good
horse.
Good news, Teddy. I found your horse.
Fuck off. Leopold, why don't you own a will? You can leave stuff to my sister.
The assistant accused me of shooting.
Again?
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 It was like, I told
did you run towards the shooting?
No, I didn't. But I went to Pedro and I said, don't accuse me for shooting this time. And then the assistant was like, oh, so you did shoot someone. I'm like, no.
Alright, I'm gonna quickly go to the bakery because I need to take a shit in the corner there.
No! Leopold!
Clyde, do you want a will?
Do I want to will?
Yeah. Considering you're getting beaten up by everyone every now and again, getting stabbed all the time.
What do you mean all the time? Happened once and it was your future
happened
employee.
Happened twice.
Twice?
Yeah.
When was that stabbed before?
Gunsmith. Or was that Booker?
Oh, that was Booker.
Oh.
No, Richard's the only person ever to have stabbed me, and I got my own back, so it's all good.
Do you want a will, though?
You
can leave stuff to your wife? Future wife?
Oh, I might get a will once we're married, but...
When you get married, I can do the marriage license and get two wills for a package deal.
Ooh. I'm not too sure. I'll have to speak logistics with the old missus, so... I will get back to you on that one, because that's... A very good idea.
Yeah, what I do is for marriages, I do the marriage license and then two wills and then two bottles of liquor.
Ooh.
All for a bundle.
How much is that?
1 second. So it used to be, I think I did it for
question,
the bundle said 900.
If you can help me out.
But I'm not doing that anymore. Yeah, very
so,
expensive. So I'll probably do that for about.
No, I know I found them before, but I can't remember where I found them.
Ooh,
just because
do
the liquor's
you know where raspberries could be?
Yes, very true.
Yeah.
I've got some
I hate
nice
when I find
wine
I don't
aging in my storage
room. Right down in my notepad where I found it.
So, the first alcohol in the Commonwealth, no.
Would you be interested in officiating the wedding?
I'd be more than happy to, but... question.
Mm-hmm.
Are you wanting it to be a religious wedding or a non-religious wedding?
Yeah, because you see,
well,
we need
to
work in the
cart
workshop.
Well, if it was religious,
so
I would have offered up my father, who's an ordained reverend for the Catholic Church.
It's very true.
And you could actually have
so
a church wedding if you want.
To make paint for them, so if people want to change the colour, you know. We need,
I've
we
never
need
really given it much thought up until yesterday, so...
But yeah, you let me know. I'd be more than happy to, but I'd have to speak to my father to find out what
roughly
they're with me. Never officiated a wedding before,
that's
even
fine.
Though I am capable of doing it.
So at the minute we're debating a few prices, but
you.
We've decided for now, for a small one it's like 900, for a medium one it's 1500,
So yeah, with Wills now, you can now leave up to an unlimited amount of items. Still only $2,500 to beneficiary. Properties, horses,
hey guys,
boats,
I
still not allowed.
Hear the conversation next to me. Could you speak up a little bit, please? Thank you.
Still not allowed to leave properties and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But now we also take down your wishes on how your body is dealt with.
Oh, okay.
So either burial, cremation, Viking fucking funeral, you know, where it gets set off on a thing and hit with flaming arrows. Then we also sort out your burial site or the site where your remains are left.
I'd have to give all this a bit of thought. Never really thought about the afterlife.
If you're looking to leave money to someone, there's a good loophole with it now, where you can leave an infinite amount of gold. Invest in gold bars and you can leave them. So.
That's very true.
Yeah.
Well, if I ever think I'm about to hit the sack, I'll go invest all my money into gold bars.
Yeah. You'd have to get your will updated. The only thing with wills, though, is they take 2 weeks to get put in effect. So, better to get them done sooner rather than later. But yeah, if you or the missus are ever interested, please let me know. There is only one beneficiary, however, you can give them instructions to distribute your items to other people. I've just received a telegram, so I'm going to go read that, but I'll be back in a minute.
You're serious about marrying Maria, or is this just joking around?
I'm serious.
Hey.
Oh, question. Will you be when you and Miles get married, will you be taking his last name?
No, Dad has made a deal with Miles that he will take the Cavendish last name because he refuses to let us change our last name.
Well, that's an obstacle I'm going to have to overcome.
Why, you want Maria to be called Cree?
Absolutely.
I get it. It is also more, you know, normal for the lady to take the man's name.
Aye.
But it is also normal and, you know, something that needs to be done to get the father to give away the daughter, you know?
Yeah.
So that's your biggest obstacle, making him walk her down the aisle. Either that or you have to wait for it when he's dead.
Oh, we could do the classical thing where we run away and do it.
Oh, yeah, you could do that. That's
run away to New Mexico.
Yes.
Get married and then return with a bunch of grandkids.
Yeah, see, I would be sad that you're just gonna be away for that long. I want to be there for the wedding.
Well, we'll run away, but we'll let certain people know where to find us on the big day.
Okay, thank you. I better be one of those people, thank you.
Oh, absolutely.
Hello.
I'm very fucking suspicious about that blacksmith tribe, man.
That blacksmith tribe, yeah. They be doing some funky shit.
Mm-hmm. Oh no, he was trying to see if any of us were assistant deputies. He's looking for easy targets.
Which guy?
The guy that was on the horse that Lisha just rode right past. Strolling past. Mm-hmm. I told both the assistants to stay inside because one of them was in their head. I told them stay inside. Don't you fucking come out until I come here.
What's the issue?
Daddy Pedro.
Assistants can't do shit. As in, like, they cannot do shit.
So if a shooter out comes, they are not allowed
They can't do shit unless authorized by a superior officer. Being a deputy or higher.
And you're a deputy?
Yes.
Good idea. Richard
Sillian.
Back here.
Stared deep into his eyes.
Are you liking your job?
Oh yeah. Every time I wake up, I'm on duty. I'll definitely need to take a little breather. at some point. But right now, I'm just, you know, making sure everybody stays safe. Making a little bit of scratch, because I kind of want to... I want a new horse.
Mm. What so horse do you have now?
I currently have a silver Mustang. It's currently in class position, ready to be trained.
Let's try it.
Okay.
And I put in an order for a blue fox trotter.
Mm.
I wanted a shire, but I can't use a shire in the line.
Claire, I think your horse kicked me. Is it that Mustang?
It's
I don't have a horse. I rid your horse up here, so.
Alright.
Or else I would have taken the shire. 100%.
Of course, it's bitter.
There is a little lady around with a big black shire, and she's kind of cute.
You and your tiny ladies.
It's fine, I knew you were.
What can I say?
Always had like a weakness for glasses and tiny women.
Yes. And as long as they have that sweet siren voice.
Excuse me.
Howdy.
I have a couple of quick questions.
Yes.
Question one.
Is there a blacksmith?
Do you know how I can get old tin cans? It's a crazy thing, but I can dig them up, but otherwise...
Who are we digging up? Are we going grave robbing?
No, grave robbing.
Guys.
That's crazy. No, I need old tin cans, and the last time I checked, I can dig them out of the ground, but that's about it.
Howdy.
Howdy, doctor.
Howdy, man.
How are you
anyway.
Doing?
Howdy. Just finding yourself?
Pretty good. Came from Valentine. I've never been covered in mud more in my entire life.
Yeah, oh, Valentine's a hellhole.
Yeah,
it's good for
the goddamn horse brush. Missy looked like shit. Shouldn't have a white horse living there, that's one thing I know for sure.
I should probably buy myself my horse a brush.
Okay. Yeah, $20 for a brush, that's ridiculous.
How much?
$20 for a goddamn horse brush.
Alright.
My horse cat costs
a
lot of money.
I hate the price.
Alright, that's a robbery. I need $20 for a brush.
You know what
oh
is
my
more?
God,
you
I'm Pedro, I'm a deputy. I have to be on duty for 20 minutes before the horse brush.
Imagine, it takes me 40 minutes to get to a point.
Howdy, Heather. Oh, fucking not Heather, Luna. Fuck!
How are you? How's your injuries? How's your injuries? My injuries? Mm-hmm. After the waterfall? Yes. Yeah, they're good. Just a few cuts and bruises. Nothing more than that. I've been in Valentine the entire day working with Evelyn.
And also
I hate
part
working
myself.
In your handover. My
do you
God.
Just feel the void creeping
oh,
closer
so
to you without
filthy.
Her being there?
Shit. I agree. I hate it too. No worries.
Send her a telegram.
Are
big telegram
right
all day.
No. Do you want
Heather,
me to
you
plug in?
You will.
Yeah. Come here. I can't hear you.
Bro, this is
do you want me to plug in? I can plug in if you want. No, you don't have to. I just in case you. Am I clocked in right now? Hold on.
I'm about as
this would be fine to be under you for a while. All right, hold on. I'm gonna clock in. In the newspaper. You don't have to if you don't want to. I don't mind, but we have to go be in the east, because everyone's in
no,
the west right
yeah.
now.
You, like, half my
yeah, well, better do that then.
Hey, don't
I
have. Get
let's go right, check, plug in.
Yeah. I'm getting like all the will business out of the way. Nope, literally, I've done
one. Abby! Oh, hi, Octavia. How you doing? You alright?
Yeah, to unlock the door
bloody.
First, that helps.
I'm pretty good. You're trying to nah, it's just yourself. Being shitty. There we go.
Yeah, unlock the door.
Luna?
So,
Jesus. Hello.
Yeah,
it is.
Hi,
oh, Luna, how are you doing? Hello. Oh, that's Eleanor, ain't it? Hi. It is. How are you doing? Hi. Frustrated, but okay. Why are you frustrated? Are you okay? Mm. Check my folder. Oh, you have a lot of corrections? Is that it? Nope. A very, very painful patient. Alright, hold on. There's so many. Oh! I'm getting. And the problem was he wasn't responding. Oh my god. It took ages.
Four gunshots wound, holy shit. Right arm through and through. Left leg lodged.
He wasn't responding to anything. It just took and
oh my god.
Took. That sucks.
Yeah, that's a lot. Give me a large bullet left leg.
That one's true.
That was so painful to do. At some point, we were so over it.
Yeah, I've only gotten. Oh, I just keep remembering that the ones the injuries I've treated before being getting the first aid doesn't count. Gee, I thought I'd done most of it. Kind of disappointed now.
Okay, plug in under a new Hanover.
Mhm.
And then we get a call. Let me see.
Thieves.
Okay.
Thieves landing?
Yeah, that's not us. That is.
Yeah,
those people.
That's...
Oh, the call we're getting in.
You lost dinner with Elizabeth.
I also see there's no people in New Austin. Do you rather want to be in New Austin?
What do we got?
I don't mind. I don't mind.
Got,
doesn't really matter where we are.
Dennis.
How are you? Good. Okay, let's go to New Austin then.
Berg.
Mm-hmm.
Have fun. You too.
Thank you.
I'm sure there's others. I can't be bothered. Be safe.
Oh.
Whoopsie. I have to go get it.
Alright. You can jump up on Missy if you want to. I don't have to walk the entire way.
There we go.
Didn't know Evelyn's horsed me to the second dimension.
What?
Yeah, her horse kicked me to the other dimension.
Oh damn.
Oh Jesus. I got quite a headache from that one.
I'm sorry.
No, it's alright. I've never seen Missy so goddamn filthy in my entire life. Looks like I've been neglecting all my horses.
Okay, since we had the call in Thieves Landing and it doesn't seem like Wyatt is gonna go for it, then let's go for it. Where are you going? You can't see my horse?
No, I can't. I think you had to put her in the same skin. Couldn't see you nor your horse.
It's okay. Oh, sorry! Sorry!
Yours.
Thank you.
What? You right?
Yeah, I just said.
Sounded like you were getting kicked or something.
No, I just kinda moved my horse right into him and I feel so bad. Anyways, it doesn't seem like Wyatt's gonna go for the call in Thief's Landing, so let's go for it.
Alright, hold on, let me just get that.
Is your horse trained or?
No, she's not yet. I'm just saving up some money. I have about $500 right now.
Okay,
I'm thinking about getting her trained by the Cray Brothers. They
Yes.
have a decent price, like $300.
They're also pretty quick about it.
Yeah.
Howdy!
Oh! He had a bad posture.
Yeah. Meow.
You're fast turning, aren't you? Are they shooting down there?
I didn't hear anything.
I thought I had a gunshot. Might have been imagined that.
Hmm.
That was weird. Oh, it's like wherever I look, I see snow in my spiritual world and here. Can't escape it whatsoever.
You don't like snow?
Yeah, I do. It's just kind of tired of seeing snow wherever I look.
Oh, I love fucking snow.
Yeah, and it's hard to leave the house. I mean, I have just trouble going outside. Especially with my dogs, too.
If I could, I would live up in Coulter.
Yeah, how come you don't do that?
Because we're not allowed to plug in under Coulter and only Coulter,
oh, yeah.
And for fuck's sake, I don't want to run all the way down to plug in and...
Yeah, makes sense.
I want to be close at home.
Yeah, I like Coulter, but I don't like the goddamn snow blizzards that are happening there.
Oh, I like
it. All passageways you can't see.
Oh, I like it. It's exciting!
Yeah, until you stumble onto a wolf and get attacked, and then you don't remember anything the next day.
That's, you just gotta not lose against wolves, it's easy.
Yeah, well I do it all the goddamn time. I killed two Timberwolves today and the third bug got me.
I get it. Oh, I hear
Did
shots.
Did you hear those big gunshots that sounded like fireworks earlier? When you were out hunting wolves?
Yes.
I was so goddamn scared I damn near pissed myself. I was in the clothing store trying to fix another outfit and then I just heard the gunshots. And then I heard someone, Luna's hunting wolves! From where the gunshots were coming, or the fireworks. Apparently it's the theater, sounding all the way from Blackwater, I think.
What the
Jesus
fuck?
Jesus Christ. Yeah. Such a loud sound. What the hell did he do? That? They like shoot cannons in the theater? Never heard that before.
Okay, let's run over here, because I feel like mm-hmm. it's over here.
Yeah. There's a lot. Oh, there's a bridge here, that's nice.
Hmm. Might be a cougar.
Yeah.
Oh. I see a horse.
Oh, there we go. There's someone over here.
Howdy, doctor's office.
Yep, me too.
Oh.
Oh, hi.
Hello.
How are things going?
Well, we noticed nobody was covering New Austin. We're covering the bottom half mm-hmm. of West Elizabeth, so we thought we'd come down here and grab this. But obviously, that's the same thought we did.
Yeah, we just plugged in under New Austin because we saw it.
Oh, sorry.
Snakes from the.
We're not trying to steal your business. We apologize.
No. It's fine. We stood beside Wyatt, and he wasn't gonna go for the call, so I was like, you know what, if we're gonna have a doctor here that's not gonna go for calls, then it's better for us to be in New Austin.
Yeah.
Than in New Hanover.
I think Octavia and Alan are doing the north half of West Elizabeth, we're doing
mm-hmm.
the southern half.
Mm.
So,
Should we do New Austin then? Or are you doing New Austin? Wait, where are we right now?
We're
in
sort of
like New Austin, kind
of. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But
there wasn't anyone in New Austin when we started coming for
mm-hmm.
this. We're like, yeah, we'll just go and, yeah. Yeah.
Do
so
you want me
to
change in the newspaper from New Hanover to New Austin?
Yes,
let's
do that.
In and out again.
So,
mm-hmm.
Luna, so you want to cover the entirety of New Austin, or do you want us to cover to a certain point, as we're only doing half of West Elizabeth? Do you want us to cover some of New Austin or not?
Since you're only covering half, you're covering
mm-hmm.
the Blackwater thing, do you mind taking McFarlane Trench and Thief's Landing as well? You know,
Yeah, so like still what's up to McFarlane's Ranch, like that area, there, yeah? I
yeah,
got you.
So
yeah.
That's, yes, awesome. Because then
yeah,
we don't have to,
we
like, if we end up being in Tumbleweed, there's not that far, you get it?
Yeah.
Is it
yeah,
snowing in the desert right now?
Yes, it's always snowing.
Yeah,
but
so
it's
we'll cover, so we'll cover up to McFarlane's Ranch and like sort of like the little area around there. So obviously you get the Kubi thing on the other side of that sometimes. We'll
yeah.
kind of cover McFarlane's, anything like to the east of there, or you know, yeah, so we'll cover that little
yes.
area there.
Awesome.
Am I the only one that can hear a snake?
Probably.
I don't. Hey, Luna, how are you doing after your rib issue yesterday?
It was so annoying because I don't know if you saw that I ended up telegramming somebody because somebody refused to let me do treatment on them.
What?
I did see that, but I didn't want to pry.
Yeah, me and Miles, my fiance, had a fight, and then he broke a leg, and he was like, "You're not gonna touch me."
What the?
So
I refused you.
Yeah, he refused for me to touch him because he was upset with me.
Us talking is not confusing or interrupting or anything, is it? Or we're not distracting you, are we?
No. I can
okay.
talk a bit more quiet if that's the case.
We could whisper. I forgot that she was doing that, so I was like, oh no.
Yeah.
How can you forget? Isn't she your assistant?
Yes.
You are keeping an eye on her, right?
Do I say?
You're keeping an eye on her, right?
Oh, 100%.
Okay.
Yeah.
But yeah, it turned into a shit show, and he was upset with me, and ugh. I have never been as pissed as I was at him that day, because... You know, he ended up having low vitals because it was bleeding. He broke his leg and it was a compound fracture. And it, the bone ended up cutting an artery. So he was bleeding a lot. And he was like, "No, don't touch me. I don't want to be touched by you." And then he got really pale. And I tried to do first aid on him. And he was still like, "No, do not touch me." And then he ended up passing out. But, you know, I already kind of sent the telegram out. And I was like, I'm not... If I end up treating him and he's going to be super upset. And, you know, it was on the brink of us breaking up. I was like, if he breaks up with me and then he starts a whole freaking investigation about me. Well, I told her not to treat me. Then with everything with Yukito as well. I was like, you know what? I'm not even going to risk
it. I had a situation like that yesterday with an assistant that wasn't even my assistant. He was Octavia's assistant. And she had pops, and I happened to see a telegram of like a panic telegram he sent out about some shit going down in Valentine, so I went to Valentine. And it was William. And the moment I walked in, he had a patient on the table who verbally and very vocally said, "I revoke my consent for this assistant treating me." Even though he was technically at the point of passing out from, chloroform.
Wait, who?
Apparently, he still managed to say, "I remove my consent." So I had to like take over, unfortunately, because I don't want to put that assistant at any risk.
Which assistant was it?
Do what?
Which assistant was it?
It was William. This person was just an asshole. Person was genuinely just an asshole. Like, this patient was genuinely a prick.
I do not understand why there's so many people against doctors at the moment. And I don't get why there's so many lawmen being against doctors at the moment. I'm like, okay.
Many doctors have you heard?
We have to deal with a really, really...
Arsehole
patient earlier in Strawberry who... It took him 7 times being asked anything to respond to anything. And course of time he never bothered responding. And but the moment he was up, he was chatting.
Give me a second, Are you both whispering right now?
Yes.
Okay, because you're both talking at the same time to me, and I'm trying to listen to both conversations.
I didn't know he was speaking.
I'm sorry.
That's alright.
Okay, Sebastian, real quick, you first.
Oh, we just dealt with a patient earlier in Strawberry who... it took so long to get any kind of visual thought from him at all for anything that we were asking, anything we were trying to do. 6-7 times in some cases we'd have to like re-ask, and yet the second he was up, he was chatty as anything. So obviously something was going on in his head, you know, probably something quite loud in his head going on, and he also wasn't paying attention and wasn't seeing anything either. It was just annoying as all shit, I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah.
I just
have someone. Who is that?
I think that's Roscoe.
Hello.
Howdy.
Hello, Roscoe.
Little doctor's conference, I see.
Yeah. What's your assistant's name right here?
It says Shayna.
Alright.
You met her in Strawberry.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah.
Actually. Why are you laughing at me? You know I have short-term memory loss. My memory is terrible.
How do you remember that?
Well, I didn't. I just wanted to... Shut up! Shut up. Shush. I'm gonna pretend that didn't happen. Some people I remember very well. Especially if they make a... significant, like, what is it called? Impression upon a first meeting, but some people just slip away. It's not that I don't like them, it's just that some people they have something special about them. Some accents, Luna, I remember being all feisty.
You remember her because of the healer's hut, I'm assuming. The herbalist house, I assume.
It was chaotic, I'm so sorry.
And I remember, I sent your brother a letter yesterday, by the way. I haven't gotten a response yet. We'll see what he says.
Whose brother? My brother?
Yeah, your brother.
Edward?
Oh. We'll see what he says.
He better soon answer, the little prick.
Yeah, I have too few men in my life.
Yeah.
But you're so handsome, Booby, and so messy. Yeah. I'm gonna buy more equipment to you, or saddle. It looks kinda... I look broke right now, only having a saddlebag and a saddle. I don't even have a bed or anything.
But what did you say about natives being against a doctor's office now?
There was a woman that was detained for, she was allegedly accused of having to have hurt a couple of doctors. Don't remember why. They're targeting, virgins. Nope. Sorry. Dangerous. Sorry.
Wait, sorry. How...
sorry.
You know what? You know, I have to
they're
walk
targeting...
away from that for a second. Hold on.
Wait. They're targeting gingers.
Okay.
Because they are apparently marked...
How do you think those two things?
They are targeting gingers for some reason. Because they are marked by fire. And they... I don't know why. But that's
what they said to me.
Wait.
What the fuck?
Who was this?
Evelyn told me. She said that they were targeting natives. No, gingers, because as the natives said, they are marked by fire. Has something with spirits to do, so we should probably warn if we have any red-headed people in the, as doctors or assistants. Shouldn't be traveling alone.
Are you a ginger?
No, I'm not. But Evelyn is.
I mean, you might as well just, you know. Just saying, you might secretly be it. Do we think she's secretly a ginger, Luna? What do we think?
Oh, I'm not,
I think she's blonde.
Yeah, I think so too. I'm very stupid sometimes.
Stupid. I hear that the blondes are more sexual active. Honestly, that's the only thing. I have never heard anyone call a blonde woman stupid.
I've only heard that the blondes are stupid.
What,
at least
really?
In my country. Yeah, they said the blondes were stupid all the time. I don't know why.
How's this going?
What the hell?
I'm good, I'm at...
more sexually active, yeah. I didn't know that. I've heard the blondes are more crazy than others.
What? No, I hear they're more sexually... Like, they're
talking,
a lot more charming and stuff.
Distracting you.
Yeah, I can actually agree with that.
I
and try to be.
Hearing right now.
Okay. Is it still? I saw the couple that were hunting doctors. Are they still active? Have you had any news on that matter? Because I saw it in the newspaper.
I haven't seen anything about it, so I don't know. Because I didn't work at all yesterday, other than the time where I thought I could treat my fiancé.
I think it was a couple of days ago, some announcements about being wary about a couple that was hunting down specifically doctors for some reason, torturing them, doing stuff like that.
Oh, I haven't heard anything about those other than that. Look out for these guys. That's it.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think they're only going for senior doctors and management, honestly.
Yeah, alright. I don't know why, though.
They have power, they know them better, because they worked in the doctor's office for years, so...
Yeah, but I mean, why would they do that? Still hunt them down? I don't... That is in... Saint Denis, Le Moyne. Do we have someone covering Le Moyne?
No, we did before.
Yeah, we have. Senior Dr. Gaius.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's why we changed down here.
Are you supposed to administer the antivenom when they are conscious or unconscious, or does that really matter?
I would say conscious.
Yeah. I suppose it's better to get consent. Oh, I had Vanessa de Graaf fucking all over the doctor's office in Valentine. I had to clean that up for hours. Somehow she managed
Vanessa?
To puke on... Yeah, somehow she managed to puke... the entire way from the entrance to the back,
see if he had any missing entries.
The back room to the medical room, and then she passed out on the medical table because I wasn't fast enough because Evelyn was helping a prisoner in the cell and she had the anti-venom on her, so then I was trying to start treating her, and then I was gonna go and grab something for her to bite down on, and then she passed out. She was stuck in the medical table, so I had to treat her beneath the medical table. Oh, it was chaotic. She was like, I'm so sorry. I'm like, alright, it's fine. You can. It's not your fault you're puking all over the place. I don't mind. I just had a good laugh afterwards. Trying to clean the ceiling up.
Let's see. Okay, let's go to New Austin. Let's not get all that out. Be safe, everyone!
All kinds of colors. Yeah, you too, be safe! She was puking all kinds of colors.
I feel bad for her. Was it Vanessa de Graaf or
yeah,
what?
Yeah, it was.
She's okay, right?
Yeah, she's fine.
Because she's my family member.
Yeah, I just wanted to check while she was conscious before passing out, but I didn't. I was too slow.
Howdy, Roscoe.
Hi, Roscoe. How you doing?
Are we? Oh,
sorry. I can hear you. Your horse.
Do you guys
think we need your horse voice?
Sorry? Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, no, I can hear you.
How you guys want to split up New Austin?
Ooh. Would you mind if we take the south? Oh, wait.
Tumbleweed and down?
You want to take Tumbleweed and down? I'll take Arma and up.
Sure.
Alright, that sounds good. I like your horse, but what you got?
This is a brown leopard.
Appaloosa. It's a beauty. It's a nice one.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I don't think I met you before, right? Yeah, I have, haven't I?
Oh, yeah.
I'm not sure.
Yeah.
God, I feel so bad. I can't remember names and faces.
It's a large department.
Yeah, it is. Like, every time I think I've met someone, I'm always throwing mixing people up.
Yeah. No, it's a very large department.
Yeah. I mean, we shouldn't complain. How many deputies aren't there?
Oh.
Lawmen. It's like 29 clocked in right now. Jesus Christ.
Right now.
Yeah. I think we're about 10 doctors clocked in. I think I thought we were many. Yeah.
You guys get any good hunting in down south?
I haven't hunted in the south pretty much.
Me neither.
Yeah, I'm mostly here in West Lisbeth or New Hanover.
Mm.
I'm seldom down in New Austin hunting. I don't like the heat. I prefer when it's a little bit colder.
Oh, no, no, no. I love the heat.
Yeah, I don't. I'm actually was born in Armadillo, so I can't stand it anymore. That's why I moved out of there.
There's where it is. Yeah. For the same reason I don't like it out east. I got here in Rhodes, and I'm like, well, how can I get the furthest away from this place?
Makes sense. Yeah, I love New West Lisbeth. New Hanover is fine, but it has a special place in my heart.
Yeah.
Especially the woods near Manzanita Post, so beautiful. How do you put up a camp? Do you buy camp supplies and a camp kit at the general store? Is that all?
Yeah.
Alright. I might do that. How much tax do they collect? Is it cheap?
Nowadays? So here's the secret. Mm-hmm. See you, Dad. Paraíso has the lowest tax rate in the Commonwealth.
Wait, what has the lowest lowest
Paraíso? Paraíso? Down in the south.
Oh, alright. Yes, different areas have higher taxes.
Pretty much out of New Austin, out of New Mexico, you got it starts to regulate when you get to Armadillo. I think, Tumbleweed's a little lower, but, Paraíso is the lowest. Yeah. So if that's at that rate, you're looking at, I want to say, maybe $24 a day, whereas Paraíso, it's like 12. Yeah. It's half of that in Paraíso.
Whoa, just left me.
Oh, there you are.
Where did we leave her?
Hold on a second.
I had a headache right on the road.
Oh.
See, I thought you rode ahead of us and just took off to Tumbleweed.
No, I wouldn't just leave my assistant. What the hell?
I don't know. I'm just like, maybe she just wants to get there.
No.
Was kicking me. Jesus,
that, yeah, she's violent. She has a body count of about 12 so far.
You're counting body counts.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
No.
I had a Criollo that had 23.
Oh my god. Wow. Well, there we go.
Yeah. And I mean, you know,
12 by the age of 14 isn't too bad.
Looks like a dog, you know.
You spoil her is what you do.
Yeah, I do. I brush her every 5 minutes.
Yeah. I'm on my second horse brush, so
yeah.
I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
Yeah, especially having a white horse, she gets filthy all the goddamn time, and I can't stand it.
Oh yeah, you must love Valentine.
Oh, I hate Valentine. Let me tell you, that's why I brought a hairbrush as soon as I got there. $20 goddamn for a horse brush. I mean, the price is in the Commonwealth.
It's extortion.
Yeah, what the hell's going on? I don't even know how long a brush lasts.
Extortion.
It better last a long time for me to pay $20 for that shit. Ugh. Well, it's nice to be back home. Haven't been here in a long time. Last time I was here was with my dad's funeral, I think. It was a few years ago. Ooh, it's a dog. Sorry, I just get...
Oh, no.
You
have to understand, I think the first time I met Luna, she got sidetracked by a mule.
Hey, don't tell on me!
I'm just saying, it was hilarious. It was just like a soft introduction, and then suddenly it was, oh, that's a mule.
Do you remember Miles Donkey? He gave me that one. Jack.
Oh, Jesus
God
Christ.
Damn, it was fast. Yeah, he gave me Jack the Jackass. He kicked everyone, so it was so goddamn stubborn. I thought I was stubborn until I met the mule, or donkey, or whatever it was. Jesus, how the hell is it snow here? I've never seen this before.
It is a sign that our ecosystem is dying, because if it snows in the desert, then something's wrong with the ecosystem.
You know, I never believed in the industrial society.
Oh, let
I
me
like
tell you something.
Ways.
It definitely snows in the desert. It just doesn't stick around
long,
that's
all. Did you just see the goddamn deer on the... What? It always happens down here.
Hey, don't pick on the roof deer. His name is Frank.
Jesus fucking
Where
Christ.
Do you see a roof deer?
I saw a fucking deer. It's always here in Armadillo, too. Never anywhere else. What the hell?
It's Francis, the roof deer.
Yeah, there!
I'm seeing it. Where?
don't shoot with it. You're gonna have trouble with the lawman.
Francis, no!
Whoa! Holy shit!
You're gonna have trouble with the lawman.
Hello.
Hello.
God damn! Yeah.
Every holy time shit. I come here, hold on, I I'm see gonna go get it.
My brain!
I got it. It's kind of struggling still. I got it. Come on. Come on. All the
it's
way up.
It's dead.
I know. I'm just making sure it's complete.
Do you want it?
Come
or...
on. Come on. Let's go. No, oh, shit.
You killed Francis.
Oh, shit. I'm
no!
sorry. Oh, God. I'm just going to put this thing away. I can't. I'm so sorry.
It's okay. It's okay.
All right. Well, oh I'm glad God. I was able to help you.
Yes,
oh,
the name is Leroy. Leroy Spracklin.
Oh,
hello, Leroy.
Oh my God. Oh.
Thank you for the help.
Oh, holy shit! Oh my God! God damn! All right, well, nice to meet you, ladies. What's your name?
My name is Luna.
She's the first one.
You said like- Luna?
Yeah, her name's
you got yeah. So my dad got ate by a grizzly bear because my mom fed him to it, and
what?
And now I get some partial amnesia and I black out. Oh shit!
Is he alright?
I think that's a managing doctor's thing, Mr. Manager.
What?
Leroy,
what
you alright?
What the?
Oh,
hell?
Oh, I'm
are
okay.
Right?
I just had this occasional. No, we're good.
He keeps blacking out.
He doesn't like doctors.
He's not right in the head. His
well, you know,
father was
doctor.
Fed to a bear by his mother.
Yeah, he just told me. You wanna know something? I was unconsensually hugged by a bear yesterday. Or was it the day before that? I don't even remember. I've never been so scared in my entire life. I damn near pissed myself.
I warn you right now, doctors are feral. So
am I feral? I take rabies
because of
pissing
yourself is kind of feral.
For no reason.
What?
See?
Jesus.
Look, she's already thinking about hitting me.
Well, let's just not hit anybody. Let's just be cordial here.
I think it's all about not being violent and only giving hugs, you know? Only giving hugs.
Maybe I did.
Oh, she's a hugger, alright.
Yeah. Do you want a hug?
Yeah, I'd like a hug.
Took a disc out. Ow.
No, like one of them hugs.
Alright, hold on.
Don't
she's
go easy on me.
She's winding up.
Oh!
That's not a hug!
Brother. That bow
what,
came
out.
Are you okay?
Oh, holy shit! This is the kind of tree hugging I like!
That is my aunt now, sir.
Oh, alright. Well, it looks better on you anyway.
Yeah, it sure does. You can take mine. No, it just disappeared.
No, yours decided to go underground with all the squirrels.
It did. I feel like a new woman in this. I feel like I gained a few.
Yeah, you look pretty good. Oh, there's my dad. Well, we can pick that right back up.
Oh, you little squirmy thing.
What am I talking about? Lasso on people?
Mr. Manager, I have a. I have
looks
something
like we got a cat fight in front of us and they want to hug each other.
I'm gonna try to dodge. Hold on.
I love that you tell me that you're gonna try to dodge as if I'm gonna hit you in front of a managing doctor.
Oh. Shit, sorry. I didn't see anything.
You didn't see anything? No, because you hit me!
No, I did not.
Well, Jackie boy,
I'm a big
I'm
fan
not
of
really
what
sure.
happened.
I'm following what's going on here.
Oh, okay.
But, let's see. Oh, yeah. Alright. Alright, well. Let's just calm down a little bit here.
You like them kinky shit, don't you? You like those
kinky
like,
shit? What are you talking about? What kinky
man.
Shit? Ha! Ha! What kinky shit?
Good.
What are you talking about?
Oh! God damn.
Whoa!
Oh, damn!
Whoa!
Well, alright, alright.
Oh, I didn't like that one!
Okay,
ladies.
Woo!
Oh,
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 Everybody,
you all now.
All right. Everything's alright.
Walk
all
right. away. No one will get hurt if you just walk away.
Look at my face. Look what you've done.
She's bleeding a little bit, Doc.
I feel like you look better now.
Leroy doesn't do his hold back, man or woman, don't matter. It's the same amount of force.
Am I prettier now?
Yes.
You look good. You got a little something on your lip, but you'll be alright.
You're alright.
Maybe you should kiss it all better.
How's it going? Hi. Very good. Just borrow my friend's hat, that's all. You're deputy, right?
No, he's
not. No, I'm not.
He's a wagon maker.
Yeah,
you're not a wagon man.
Yes, yeah,
I am.
Like I was thinking about the vest. I was getting
they say
let me try this little feather hat on real quick, see if it fits my head. Oh, it's a little small.
Man, that's dumb as shit.
Whoa! That's my hat! It's my favorite hat!
Oh! Oh! Yeah, shut up!
What'd you say?
Uh-oh. That was Leroy. That wasn't me. I don't want no part of this.
What?
He told you to shut up right here, this man. Leroy Jane.
No. That was the man that...
This one right here.
Why are you pointing fingers? Yeah, you better be good, boy.
Because I don't want to catch no hands from them.
What?
You're just a slimy little snake.
Whoa, don't get behind me like that. I know
what
you do when you get behind
people. My job.
Yeah!
You deserve it, Leroy. You deserve it, brother.
Hey, after all that wrestling...
Yeah, go ahead, choke me out. I think I can handle it.
What are you talking about?
Oh, never mind.
Okay.
I'm pulling back myself. Don't turn around. What the hell?
Oh, appreciate it. Yeah, I haven't had one of those since me and Leroy took a bath together the other day.
Yeah, that was awesome.
You think I'm the deluxe lady? What the hell? I'm signing out now. Shit.
What did I say?
Compare me to the deluxe lady.
Who's the deluxe lady?
No, they're comparing you to each other.
Oh, sorry.
They took a bath together.
Yeah.
I don't know if you guys caught that or
not. No, they didn't caught that. They've been tackling each other this whole time. They probably got a concussion.
Whoa!
What?
I like to...
Just like that. Leroy, get on up. Shake it out, brother.
You got bullets on your hand.
Yeah, I do. I'm dangerous. Grr!
Is my nose crooked?
Let me take a good look at it here.
Nah, you're beautiful, honey.
It's kind of pointing to the right just a bit, but...
Yeah, well, it wasn't pointing that way before. I had a pretty nose before.
You always have a pretty nose. It's still pretty.
Oh, god damn it! right on the stomach. There we go. Tumble.
He's like a turtle. He's got to be rolled over.
I'm a human tumbleweed.
What is going on here?
Not much, sir. How you doing? Welcome.
Howdy.
What you doing?
I was looking for a gunsmith, but he's not in town, it seems.
Alright, Jackie, let's go,
Have you been in Rhodes?
Alright, Leroy, well, I appreciate
No,
that.
I wasn't Tumbleweeds. In Tumbleweed, he was there before.
Oh, okay. I know the gunsmith Rhodes is normally awake at this hour.
Alright, well, you ladies have a nice
Where is
afternoon.
That?
Be careful.
Yeah,
that is in the east.
Come on, Leroy.
In the east. Alright. I'll go have a look there then.
Thank you very much. Of course.
Likewise.
I think we just scared him off.
Damn right. I've got this nice hat.
Where is the tailor store? I think I'm gonna put my corset on. Hold on.
Down the street a little ways, just past the bank. On the right.
So that was fun.
That's her left. Your medical right.
Your medical right? Yes. Yes. So are you? How are you, Roscoe?
I'm awake. I'm still sucking air. I must be doing something right.
Oh, that's the most depressing answer of, I'm still alive.
No, it's not.
I'm still sucking air. So I guess I'm okay.
Yeah, I'm alright.
I'm alright.
No, seriously, like, I'm loving life. This is great.
It's good, it's
good. No, I just said to your life is great already.
What's that?
Nothing. You heard anything? Did you hear a bird whisper? I didn't hear anything.
Oh, I heard you say something.
Did you hear anything, Luna?
No, I was kind of looking at your corset.
Oh yeah, it's nice.
Yeah, it's very nice.
Look, they're skinny. I had a few ribs removed to put this on, I think.
Really?
Ooh. Wait, hold on.
I don't know if I can sign up for these uniforms, ladies.
Oh, look, my tits look all... Sorry.
This is not a good look for me.
You know what?
We should stand on each side of him, honestly.
Yeah,
that's,
my
that
tits
makes more
look all
oh,
like...
no.
You see this?
It's also very warm here, so it's fine.
Yeah, my tits look all warm and sweaty right now.
Why are you looking so much at your own tits? Stop looking at your titties!
Well, because I'm looking down, and that's the only thing I see. When I look down, I can't see anything else.
Wow. I'm sorry for being flat-chested here.
How do you say that?
I can see my toes.
There she is.
Whoa.
Right,
come this way.
Alright, we're going to Time Queen then.
With manager, your doctor's
voice? Yeah.
Yes.
Should we see how far we could get before he sends telegram?
I think we're able to get very far. I wouldn't do it, because I don't think he has it stapled here, right?
Probably not. And I have my horse too. Where the hell did yours go? Oh yeah.
Yeah, I had a hit pup, so
jeez.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's gone.
She's probably. Oh!
Woohoo! Doctoring! Parkour! Parkour! Horse parkour! Woohoo! I know, I'm pretty cool. Coolest doctor to every shadow. I know. Mm-hmm. No need for applause. No need for applause, ladies! I'm all here. Every
I just
day.
Like having you all to myself.
Oh,
that's
yeah, that
it.
Is rare. This is not something
yeah,
you get a lot.
Yeah, it sure is. It's either mice running around or some other assistants.
Yeah. I'm a tough nut to be alone with.
Just trying to have you all for myself.
Yes.
I feel like I spend more time with you than with your brother. And that's kind of... It's true. But he's the one that's my admirer, so it's kind of ironic. Every time I see him, he's probably with Alexander or asleep. Or somewhere else in uniform.
He's usually in uniform. I don't see him that much either. I feel like I've only seen him like twice.
Yeah, I've seen him like 3-4 times right now.
That is so
weird. Might be more, might be less. It's kind of nice actually. The cold makes my nipples turn on. I don't know why.
It makes your nipples what?
It's a nice contrast. I'm sweating, but it's still cold outside. You heard what I said.
Am I screaming?
I hope not.
I hope not, because I don't know how to feel about this information.
Yeah, well, you're welcome. It happens to all of us sometime. Should we go to Tumbleweed?
If you want to, we can.
No,
we should probably check if the saloon owner is open, because I do like the pulled pork.
Yeah.
And I'm all
I don't think it seems kind
of
quiet down here, though.
It's always quiet down here. That's why I want tumbleweed, because then we can go mining.
Yeah. Howdy. Oh, I hear a snake around here.
Go kill
it.
Get at it.
Yeah.
Get.
Where is it? Hold on.
I don't know. Kill the snake. Do you see it? Shh.
No, but
just
I could hear it. I heard it. I think it's like by the entrance.
Shh.
What the hell are you making for? What the hell is that noise?
I'm a snake.
You're trying to mimic the snake?
Yes.
I'm gonna accidentally hit my own horse. Don't wanna do that.
Some slithering snakes around here. Hear a lot of hissing.
Yeah,
yes.
Trying to mimic a snake.
Oh, well, what do they call you, Miss Slytherin?
Miss Slytherin.
Oh, what was that? I gave him a nickname the other day. Venomoose.
Oh, it's you two. You just decided to change. Y'all going to some event or something?
Yeah, what is all this fancy attire you got going on here?
This is our body armor. Corsets. Made of whalebone.
Whalebone?
Body armor?
Yeah. Yeah, well, it's kind of female body armor. In disguise, you know.
Yeah, I think I know.
Yeah, and it's kind of hot out here for some reason. And it's snowing too, I can't even comprehend what's going on here. Oh, that's a bird, Jesus. It's flying so low right now, what the hell?
Yeah, just went underground.
Yeah.
Are you guys usually around these parts?
Not actually, I'm mostly up in West Elizabeth. I prefer Blackwater or Strawberry, actually. What about you guys?
We just moved in here. We're gonna try to establish ourselves. No, we ain't new, but we're not really welcome in many towns.
I can't imagine why.
Have you ever heard of the Breadless?
I have not, actually. I'm pretty new to the Commonwealth altogether.
Oh, alright. Well, are you guys looking to join any crew, or just kind of be like on the side of a crew, like open hands?
Well, that depends on what you mean by that.
Well, we don't typically do, you know, your typical. Yeah,
we're
a little more non-traditional, but you two seem like that kind of type with all that hugging you were doing earlier.
Well, I have had my fair share of experiences in my life.
All right, well, let's just see how fast you can draw a gun. Go ahead. Let's see.
Not that fast.
Yeah, I was a bit slow. What about your mute over here? She looks like she could draw a bow pretty quick.
No, I'm horrible at that. I just beat shit up.
Well, are you good at talking?
Talking?
You think you can? Yeah, like...
Good at talking, yeah.
Let's just put a scenario in this one, right? It's just a couple farmers just minding their business, right? But we're trying to, you know, borrow a few things from them. How would you go about doing that in the most, you know, undercover way?
Undercover way?
Undercover way?
You want to borrow? What do you want to borrow?
Like, you know, rob them.
Oh, okay, listen. Okay, I'm going to be real honest with you. Somebody tried to teach me how to rob people, and they agreed that I am impossible to get to rob people because I am too nice.
Whoa. No, we have a couple impossibles, and we made it possible.
Okay, listen. They ended up saying, okay, because there was this guy who wanted to, you know, come in with the train for the first time, and we made a scenario we agreed with law, so we agreed that I was allowed to, like, take him and, you know, get him up on a hill and, like, rob him. And I was like, okay, sir, put your hands up, please. Thank you. Could you... I'm gonna take a few money, okay? Just a few, okay? Thank you. Thank you for corroborating. Thank you. And then I left. And that is how I work.
I know exactly how to...
A lot of thanks and a lot of
please. That's a bit too polite.
Exactly.
Alright, try it again, but be a little more aggressive.
Especially if you cut this
Yo,
vein.
Sir, put up your hands. Thank you.
Wow.
Thank you.
Why should I do that?
Because he tells you
it's going to help you out in the long run, okay?
It's going to help me out?
Yes.
Put your goddamn hands up.
There we go. That's what I like to hear.
Again.
Thank you.
There we go.
More conviction.
All right, let's reset. I think you got it, brown shirt. Go ahead. Walk about 5 paces behind you, and then come back, and let's see your best effort.
Brown,
I need some aggression.
Yeah.
Mr. Brown shirt, because mine is...
Did I do that bad?
Brown hat. No, you did good, white hat. You're hired if you want to join. Shoot.
I'll keep that in mind.
All right, hold on. This is her final act. Let's see what you got.
Hands up.
Who are you pointing at?
All right, well,
thank you so much.
No, don't say thank you so much, ma'am.
Yeah. Oh, no,
you.
I'm
so you don't want to say thank you.
Or I'm gonna get you.
Okay, we try again.
Okay, here we go. This is our best. This is our best right here.
Hands up. Much appreciate it.
No,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no,
No! No, I want to hear hands up, you dirty, smelly piece of shit. I'm about to take everything you ever had since you were born. That's what I want to hear.
Okay, okay.
Alright.
Just a fair warning, y'all. It is getting real dusty in town, if y'all ain't noticed.
Oh,
yes, it is. It's getting real dusty. Oh.
Just send your horse. Just send your horse away. Right. That way it is here.
Oh my god!
I'm sorry. Are you okay?
How many concussions does this woman have?
Too many.
That man just appeared in my eyes.
Yep, yeah, like I said.
It's very
stable. Piece of shit. Oh, I just watched about six people vanish leaving. So.
Yeah, she done evaporated.
Look at my goddamn blue eye. I've never looked more pretty in my entire life.
The desert's getting to my eyes.
Yeah, you look like one of them clowns in one of them circuses.
You really shouldn't say that to me.
Okay, I got this, I got
this. Why, what you gonna do about it, huh?
Whoa, don't speak to her like that!
There we go! That's what I wanna see!
I got 10 bucks on the list.
Now I know how to get you riled up! Alright, yeah, one more time before the sandstorm comes in.
You really shouldn't say that to me.
Okay, okay.
Or I'll be going again. Reset.
Put your hands up.
Look at my blue eye.
I'm looking at your big black and blue eye.
Yeah. You shouldn't really say that to me, should you?
Oh,
put your hands up.
Oh,
hands up.
Oh,
hands up.
Shit. Oh, there it is. There it is.
Hands up.
Hold on, I want to be just like you.
Wait, how do you do that?
I don't know.
Oh.
He's a big boy, he can take it.
Oh, no, that's not.
Yeah,
oh. No. Oh, she don't fell down.
Yeah, well, that's the only way I know how to do it the most effective way.
Oh.
Alright, hold on.
This one? Where you're like your little mouth breather? Your mouth breather?
Right, the rip. Yeah.
Wait, hold on.
Oh, my hair.
I don't know if I can make much more in this, honestly. I'm, my heart's kind of beating a little slow here, even if you catch my drift.
You'll be alright. There's a doctor nearby. They're just trying to get some licks in.
Yeah, there's two of them right here.
I don't got no money, Jackie boy. I can't pay for a doctor.
I'll pay for it. Don't worry.
It's free.
It's free.
Nothing's free.
It
Never.
Is free.
It is.
It is free.
We're doctors.
It is free. Trust
Are
me.
You? Oh, you're doctors?
We're both doctors.
Yeah.
I'm a doctor.
Well,
she's my assistant.
Nice. No. Well, we could use some doctors in our crew. That's for sure.
Put your hands up.
Put your hands up.
I should appreciate.
No, not much appreciate. I want to hear. Put your damn hands up. Give me all your money.
Put your muffin hands up.
Muffin?
I don't like cursing.
Okay, put your
motherfucking piece of shit hands up. I'm not gonna tell you twice.
That's what that's it, just like that.
Ooh. Not a mic.
He's a bear. Half bear, half man.
I like bears. Let's say I like bears. I do.
I mean, that's good. Then I mean, you can spend time with the bear.
Mhm. I like Harry Man too. That's nice.
I got me some suspenders.
What?
All right, let's see your final go. Come on.
Suspenders.
Got this. I'm just minding my business, right? Just walking down to the Commonwealth, and then I want to see what you got. All right? You gotta catch me around the corner.
Whoa! I ain't catching nowhere. Stop, sir.
What's that?
This is a lawful investigation. Put your hands up, please.
Investigation? I don't see no badge.
You don't need to see any badge.
I need to see some identification.
Okay, look, give me a second. Is this enough? Huh? Is this enough? Huh? You gonna put your hands up?
Okay.
Huh?
Yeah, I put them up. Girl.
Good.
All right. I don't mean nothing by it.
Good. I take
now
your hat.
What you want me to do?
A lot of attitude to be that ugly.
You're gonna turn around right now.
Okay. Now what?
And then you're gonna go over to your friend right there, and you're gonna give him a little slap.
Stand on your goddamn knees.
down on all four. I'm not asking you again. Oh, yeah, you did it.
All right.
Jesus Christ, you actually did it.
I'm the obedient type.
Yeah, eat the grass. I want to watch you eat the grass.
Okay. No, I'm not eating grass. Now I am.
You can eat mud.
Oh, oh, damn!
That's just
that hurt
me.
A bit.
Are you okay, Zach?
No, I'm not sorry at all. Don't mind me.
Well,
what did you mind licking my boots, too?
Yeah, your boots tasted a little bit like shit.
Yeah, Diego, are you okay? I'm so sorry.
I'm hurting a bit. I'm gonna need a friendly doctor to do some doctoring.
Yeah, I can be friendly. Do you want me to be friendly now?
I mean, well, you can try, but I don't think you got it in you. Yeah, you heard me.
Is that your go-to every time, just a back massage?
A back massage? I need a goddamn head massage. I just got kicked.
Wait, you're actually down?
No, I ain't
no,
down.
He's
I'm
fine.
Just, you know, I'm just playing it out.
Alright.
Can you step off my hand, please? It kind of hurts a bit.
Sorry.
That's my shooting hand.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, look. Now I look just like you. I got a nice old little eye thing going on. We can call ourselves the Bruised.
Hold on.
What, why are you poking me?
Herbal salt, once it's a bruised area.
Oh.
Should feel a bit better.
No one's ever been this nice to me before after beating my ass.
Yeah, well, it's my... It's... yeah, well, you're gonna rile me up, so it's your own fault.
We should go hunting.
I know, I did kind of rile her up.
Yeah, you did. You got me going.
Your friend here, though, she's getting better at it. Except for the please and thank yous.
Yo.
Yeah. You know, she's too friendly for her own good. Her father even says that.
I am not.
You are. You're so goddamn are.
I am not.
We need
if
to
you
teach
saw
you
a gold
some cuss
bar in front
words.
Of you, you wouldn't even take it. You would just stare at it and then go to the deputy and say, I saw a gold bar over here. Do you want it?
I was actually just scolded because I have a tendency to carry something valuable on me because I feel bad when people rob me and I don't have anything.
Oh
and
my
like,
god.
They should
you want to help out the robbers?
Like, if they're taking the risk on robbing me, they should at least get something. It doesn't seem fair that all they get are kind of, let me see, snake venom right now.
Oh my gosh, this poor naive woman. Do not let her leave your side because she would get in a lot of trouble.
I'm going to go ahead and... I'm gonna go catch some shut eye, so you all three have fun, and I'm gonna go to the tavern and drink myself to sleep.
Good night.
All right, Leroy, all be careful there, bub. Nope.
Oh, he didn't get it.
He almost made it.
Far.
He likes to sleep on the ground. He was raised by a bear, so I mean, I can.
Can I drag him to the?
Nope.
Go ahead and hog time, honestly. Yeah, he'll be all right.
Well, she's helping him.
She seems nice.
She is nice.
Are you a hunter? You like to hunt?
I do.
You want to try to go get something out there in the pasture?
Sure, but I don't have my horse because I ended up having a headache on the way, so it's all the way in Strawberry.
Well, we can always borrow a horse. Hey.
Sure. You want to go hunt?
Yeah, let's go hunting.
We're not gonna. Yeah, we're gonna. Wait, what time is it? Is it 1?
No, there's an hour.
Oh, yeah, that's. Then why the hell did I send my horse off?
Because it was getting dusty.
I don't know, 'cause it kicked you in the face.
Yeah, that's my horse. Why, Jeep's a cop? I'm spoiling her way too much. That's probably why. Every time I try to be a little bit restrictive, she just rides out.
Yeah, she seems pretty big, too. She fast?
Yeah, she is. Extremely fast. I love white horses. They're always bullied by the other horses.
Should we go hunting?
They're kind of special.
Yeah, let's go hunting.
Let's go get a horse.
Alright, let's go. Let's go be. Let's kindly ask for one. Shoot.
I think there's one over here.
It'll be alright.
We do just got a call in Tumbleween. See that?
I did.
Yeah, you can't go through this fence even how much, no matter how hard you try.
That's bullshit. That's honestly bullshit.
No, you can't jump over it, but you can't go through it. You know, the physics, law of physics, you never heard about that?
I didn't go to school.
Yeah, I did. I quit after a few years.
I don't know where you can hunt here.
There's animals everywhere. Just hanging around. There might be some hogs, maybe some deer.
Everywhere.
I'm not a very good shot. I usually run up to it and beat the shit out of it.
I mean, that works, shoot.
I'm good with a bow, but not with a gun. I've tried to.
I don't have a gun.
Yeah, I'm pretty good with a rifle, though.
I don't have a gun. Oh.
Yeah.
You said you don't have a gun?
Nope.
I can give you a gun.
No, thank you.
What kind of gun you got? Is it a Cattleman?
I think yeah, it's one of them basic ones, but...
Yeah, I got him. I hate the Cattlemans. I have one right here.
Alright, just keep your eyes peeled. I'm sure there's something out here.
Yeah, hoping Luna does, because she's riding this thing. Never know.
Luna, nice to meet you, Luna. I'm Jax.
Nice to meet you, Jax.
Jax Taylor?
Jax Taylor. Oh, I've heard how do you know you. That?
I've heard about you.
Okay.
You're kind of famous around here.
I'm famous?
Mm-hmm,
well, shoot.
Sure are. I'm Abigail. Nice to meet you.
You said Abigail?
Mm-hmm. My friends call me
Abby.
Can I call
you Abby for short?
Yeah, you can. My friends call me Abby. Where the hell is all the animals? They should be here.
I know. I think you're scaring them off with that big old gun in your hand.
Alright. Put it away then.
Here, piggy, piggy, piggy.
I'd even say we're snake right now. Oh, that's an iguana right there. Can I shoot it?
Let's see if you got it.
I can't see it in the grass.
Yeah, I see. Hold on. Mine's too mixed up in the bush. Oh, there we go. Thought I was out of bullets, but I'm not. That's good. Just had to reload this thing.
Oh, there we have something. Something's scrambling.
We have. There we have something. There's a bighorn sheep over there.
You got it. Gonna, nice and steady, like.
No, not from here. You gotta go right.
Oh yeah,
here.
There's a.
It's running
yeah,
away.
There's two of them.
Wait, where's the second one?
They're both right next
oh,
to each
yeah,
other.
Oh yeah, there we go. Wait, hold on.
Oh!
I think you did both.
Oh, there's one just going over the hill. You got that one, Abby. Oh, there's two! I'm coming with you.
There's three.
Let's get them.
Lisbeth. I can't skin this one! Do you not see the deer?
increase that call. All right.
Not here.
Where's Elizabeth?
Yeah, oh, y'all got a call?
Yeah. No, it's not for us.
We get him.
Can you see this one?
Which one?
Nope.
No.
There's
no,
one
I don't see none.
I think it disappeared.
Because it's here from
if
me,
they
but
don't
I can't
flee
see it.
From you,
oh, they didn't flee. It was so far away, so I just shot it far away.
Yeah, you gotta get up nice and close before you finish the job.
I did. It was struggling,
I
so I stabbed
sneak
it.
Sneak up on him and then just hit him when they don't see me.
Yeah, let's. We gotta be sneaky about this.
Get over here!
Thank you.
Oh, shit. No.
You fooled us, Luna.
You little shit.
Whoa!
You find anything? We only find coyotes, so it's really a fruitful area to hunt.
I found some pigs and let me check. I opened my map for.
Just a couple coyotes.
Lizards. Ram, reptiles, pronghorn.
I don't even mind hunting lizards anymore. God, I hate them, the taste of them.
You know, it'd be real fun is some gators.
Yeah.
Why do we hunt gators? Other than
those are the good ones.
Yeah. I killed 3 grizzly bears today. Almost got attacked by it.
You always get attacked by grizzlies.
Yeah, I do. What did you say? I kill grizzlies. I do. It's fun.
Well, aren't you brave? Y'all killed a bobcat yet?
Yeah.
Yeah, I have. A few.
Very nice. Y'all some master hunters.
I have yet to go down.
I outran a goddamn grizzly bear today. It escaped with some arrows in the head, but...
Small but violent.
I'm not that small. I'm pretty tall for a woman.
Yeah, I guess you are kind of tall. Both of you are pretty tall. Oh, you got that bird.
It's flying weird. I think it's stuck in a loop or something. It's gonna disappear. I don't want to waste any arrows on that one.
Couldn't agree more. What do you say, Luna?
What?
You see something?
I was going for the bird.
Oh, alright.
I don't care about wasting ammo.
yeah. Oh, that one? Wait, hold on.
I don't see that one.
Yeah. It just keeps doing the same thing over and over.
It's in the goddamn... No, it just been.
Must be something in the water here.
Yeah. Lots of medical, you see that? Bruising on torso.
I feel very badass with this hat.
Yeah, you do look kind of good in that hat.
Damn right. Despite me not having a gun.
Yeah, well, you don't need a gun.
I am in danger.
I'd never use my gun, let me tell you. I only use my bow.
I may or may not have used it a few times.
Yeah, I bet you have. Oh, I was just trying to walk in this shit.
Oh, shoot. Right up there.
Oh.
Yeah, we can do it. Careful there, Luna. Don't miss. Yeah, I guess we gotta chase.
Did you get it?
Nothing. Yeah, I got it, Luna.
Good job.
You got it.
Appreciate it.
Can I fall down here? Is it that steep?
I don't know yet.
It's not. Woohoo!
I don't see none.
It's just a good position, not in a bush, and yeah.
Are you trying to hide here?
No, it was just I could see a lot here, so I wanted to see if I could see anything.
Wait, hold on.
Got you. You're doing pretty well.
Thanks, Luna.
Of course.
I think it's just down over this hill. I saw one more.
I can hear it.
Right there, yeah. Great shot.
Oh, I nearly hit her. God fucking dang it. Shit.
sit tight and wait for them to come to us, honestly.
That's a good idea.
I killed a bird and I can't find it. It should be right here. There it is.
Well, we're trying to sneak hunt here. You're kind of spoiling it all.
Good shot.
Okay, well, I said all the
I'm out of water, so I will have to go and get water. Am I super low? I'm gonna have to go. I can't hear anyone, so see ya. Sebastian's still here. Yes, okay, cool.
Yeah, he got bit by a snake.
I would say look at the bad hat, but he's not wearing one today.
And he was too stubborn to ride off without me, and I'm like, Roscoe, go get fucking treated. And yeah, he kind of passed out when he got here. Oh, here comes my cow.
My assistant is over there. By the saloon. What the hell, a cow?
Is your assistant first aid trained?
Yes.
Yep. Well, you can do it.
Alright, howdy.
Roscoe got bit by a snake, apparently.
No.
Come on, Mama.
What the hell is that? Alright.
Do you know?
Alana's now a cow trainer, not a horse trainer, so.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I thought he'd go and, like, check the injuries real quick.
Do you have any, do you know if the saloon is open? Because I am thirsty.
Don't think so. But he's usually asleep at this time.
Jesus Christ. Okay, let's see how I do.
What injuries you have sustained? Alright, ankle. Have you, applied a tourniquet?
Nope. Literally just got here.
Yeah, we got here at the same time, so no worries.
Alright, going to apply the tourniquet. You have to take it off every 5 minutes, right? Or is it 5, 10 minutes? Something like that.
The tourniquet?
A little bit longer, but you shouldn't need to remove it until after you're done. Snake bites are pretty quick, so.
Yeah.
Alright.
If you're clocking in down here, you'll learn to do them real fast.
Sarah, do you mind keeping an eye on her so I can quickly go fill up my flask?
Yeah,
take care.
Oh,
Howdy.
Cool, that's cool. Yeah, you take him.
Another snake bite.
I don't know.
Hello? Can you hear me, man?
Yeah, I thought you couldn't hear me because I tried to talk to you and nobody answered.
Oh, no, I couldn't. You just took him off me. That's all. That's the good thing. I didn't know you were a doctor. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Alrighty,
I'm not sure. Can he even see me? Do you know if he can see me? Oh, okay. He can. Sorry.
He's just slow in the head. Oh, yeah, he's, he got, someone beat him up.
Okay.
Is everybody coming into town, Thornton? Oh, yeah, I forgot about that. Throw down that cupcake. Yeah. Well, this is gonna be rough.
Lungs, you gonna go get some lungs?
You talking to me, man? Hello? My name is Ace. How about yourself? Howdy, man. How you doing? Probably. Probably strawberry. Bo.
on my Uncle Morris. Yeah, it was I mean Bart I was with as well, I think. He probably someone probably had him. He always getting bitten by snakes and such. Can't help himself.
Boop, boop.
Yeah, my brother and then yeah, ma'am, what was your name? Nagini? Me? Finding anything? Oh, I see. Well,
hello, do you mind telling me your full name?
I'm a blacksmith, so I like rocks, you see. So if you bring me some rocks, you know.
My name is Friedrich Schwarz.
Oh, you're trying to hit me. Yeah.
Do you mind writing it down for me?
No, I wouldn't. Probably wouldn't like that.
I can spell it for you real quick.
Sure.
Don't.
If or E.
F R I E D R I C H.
D R what?
D R I C H.
I
rich.
No, please don't.
Yep, and then S.
S.
C H.
I look forward to that.
H.
W. A. R. Z.
Thank you, thank you. And I've been level from 1 to 10.
Just dizzy, so just a 2, a 1, I'd say. I'm just feeling a little dizzy still.
Okay, if you feel a lot dizzy, then please sit down, drink some water. It might feel a little weird. It seems like you did have some strangling marks on your neck that will probably be there for a few days, but I felt nothing major. Your vitals were a little low. I am assuming that is from lack of air, so I do suggest for you to take it very easy in the next couple of hours.
Oh, okay.
Other than that, you're all good to go.
All right. Vielen Dank. I appreciate your help.
Of course, cheers.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Hey, Frederick, how you doing? You all right now?
You know what really annoys Roscoe?
I got a little bit of
fear. What are you talking about? Is Roscoe here?
Yeah, he was. I think he's just taking a nap, but... If you want to really annoy him, just call him sir.
Nope.
Okay.
Mr. Dr. Roscoe, sir.
Mr. Dr. Roscoe. Are you putting me up for failure? Am I gonna be in trouble with him now?
No.
You guys take care. Oh.
Nah, I don't believe you.
Goodbye,
Goodbye.
Bye, man.
Goodbye. Yep, we're doing right.
Sorry about just leaving my assistant here. I was about to head out.
Fine. Yeah, it's fine. Oh, down to my last 2 pulled pork sandwiches.
Yeah.
They have not lasted long, as long as I hoped they would.
I hate that we get so stressed out just by writing, honestly. Because as a doctor, that's all we do.
Really annoying. I feel like they've done it because Law doesn't get stressed at their offices anymore.
Wait, so Law doesn't get stressed?
No, you don't get stressed in the Law office.
Oh, that's nice.
Well, they used to get stressed there now. So that they would be forced to go out on patrols, but they just bought anti-stress stuff instead. And they just always sit on the porch anyway. So they just removed it, because, you know, clearly it wasn't working. So that unfortunately has meant that everyone else gets stressed from writing, I think. Oh my god, I'm
which
sorry.
Which kind of kills the purpose of them going on patrol, because now they get, stressed out for working.
Yeah, I don't get it. No, we never did name the skull on the desk.
What?
Let's call him Dresk. We never named him.
Oh, I think he looks like, Michael.
Hmm.
Maybe a different?
I'll have to think about that one.
Gonzales. Hello, Gonzales. Gonzales?
Oh my god. No, I don't know.
I feel like you're really saying no to all of my ideas.
I think Michael doesn't really fit, but Gonzales? Yeah, feels like that's naming it for someone.
What IQ it was.
Yeah. I'm gonna have to. I can't.
Oh, I know you can't pretty. Have IQ.
Oh!
Oh! Careful there.
Cow trainer. Where's your cow trainer? Yeah. Cow trainer.
I could go give cow print. Mm-hmm.
Oh, should probably sell all the meat I've got. Where's the butcher's table?
Alrighty, show me what you've got. Just set your stuff down for me right here.
There we go.
I don't want that.
Gotta do some cooking too.
I'm not interested in that.
Oh, I wanna start making it like medicine and stuff like that. Why the hell you don't want my modelo shell, you goddamn piece of shit then? Don't take it. Jesus, don't have to be so rude about it.
Yeah, you tell him, girl. Fuck this guy.
See you later.
Alright, take the snake venom. So that you can make any venom. There we go.
I don't know.
Kill the rattlesnake. You have, I think you have boiled water, refined oil, and something else.
Oh.
Where can I cook the food?
Over here.
Well, we meet again.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Is that the blacksmith? Of Tumbleweed?
No, that's my brother, Frederick.
Ah.
Yeah. I ain't no blacksmith.
He does look a little bit. He's a little shorter and fatter, though.
Me?
And then the blacksmith of Tumbleweed. I ain't saying no, I'm not being mean, I'm just telling right. the truth.
I'm just making sure.
Okay. Yeah, I'm not being rude, I'm just telling them the facts, you know. The facts.
The facts.
Hey.
yeah. Okay.
Oh. Are you bored, Luna?
This is how I stay skinny.
Yeah, well, makes sense.
You don't want to go, Frederick?
Staying skinny is for the weak.
okay.
Yeah, well,
I have to disagree.
That's what we say in Germany. A well-fed man is a good man.
Is that what they say?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, the bigger you are, the more wealthy you look. That's true.
But also, make sure you're using your wealth on food.
Bad harvest, he would survive. He would out-survive us. That's true. That's good survival 101 right there.
It's not true.
It is true. You survive longer, the more the more you have on your body.
That's true. You see all this running around, you're gonna be tired. We ain't running, so we're not tired.
Yeah, I just got tired running around and hunting. I need to go. Oh, Luna!
I'm getting tired watching you. But
I'm sorry.
Mind
your manners.
Yeah.
What have I said to you?
Yeah, you be careful,
to get...
Frederick.
I'm surprised you... Oh, wait, hold on.
Oh.
Oh, now she's on me.
Not me, brother.
You okay?
I'm fine, thank you.
Well, I'm alright too, thanks for asking. Oh. Oh, and there we go. Christ.
No, my name is Luna, you don't have to call me Christ.
Okay. Nah.
Come
on, Frederick, have a go.
Not that.
Don't strangle her.
Oh, I will. She tackled my brother.
No. Listen, stop. I'm
whoa, whoa.
Right.
We don't want to do this.
Yeah, you don't want to do that.
We don't want to do this.
It's dangerous.
Wait.
Oh.
Shit.
Frederick, you alright?
I'm doing just fine.
Yeah, I don't know.
She bouncing off my belly, you see, this is why it's going to be a little fat.
I have a soft landing.
Is he going again?
Yeah!
Oh!
Be careful, he's going to be going back to the doctors. You're going to have to help him again.
I am a doctor!
Yeah, you're going to have to help him again. You only just helped him.
Helped earlier?
Yeah.
That doesn't make much sense. Jesus.
Oh, you're right.
Is that how you earn your money? You just put them back into...
Yeah.
You're getting paid per...
Some corruption
per
right
help.
There.
That's some corrupt shit.
No!
I know, I agree. It's not good. Anyway,
just
we'll
getting
get out of here now. I want to be on the floor again. Like that. My
here,
friend,
I
let's go real quick. Oh, never mind. We're staying. Fuck.
I don't think you
okay. Frederick, help me.
Ah, you handle.
No,
you got this.
Almost married.
Oh, she got me good.
Oh, he put it up a butt.
No.
How the
back. Get back.
Ow!
Oh,
oh
shit.
You
take
turn in the booth.
My bad, ma'am.
It's okay!
Get off of me! Ah.
Don't strangle him!
Jesus Christ, help!
Do my math to find out! She has a fiance, if you can believe it. Oh my God!
I got her! Run!
Jesus! You're just burning her over there, can't you?
Oh!
No!
Jesus!
Uh-oh, not again!
She has a fiance.
Yeah, this ain't me. I'm the victim here.
Mm-hmm. And the fact that you said as if he's not. Din din. Din 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 din.
Jesus.
I think I'm gonna cook my food in Blackwater from now on. I don't usually get tackled near as much.
Yeah, well.
Maybe tumbleweed. Pretty far.
She only does this here for some reason. She's fun otherwise.
What's
I've
your name, ma'am?
I'm Abigail. Her name is Luna.
Luna.
Cavendish.
Cavendish, okay.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna keep her eye on that one. What the hell
I
are you doing?
Wonder.
You're trying to sneak up on.
What's your
name like that?
What's your relation to Richard, ma'am?
It's my father.
Oh, that's your dad, okay. You alright there?
Wait!
Nope. Well, I'm not.
Sure. Why? Do you know my father? In a good or a bad way? Look at all the
I
hats.
Haven't decided yet.
Because he's a lawyer?
No, not because of that.
Is your father a lawyer?
I'm
Ace Bramwell. And we seem to have some kind of an issue with the Cavendish, but I don't know why.
Oh,
I I have a feeling it might be because they keep tackling people. I wonder.
Yeah, it might be.
Well, your dad hasn't tackled me just yet, so.
Yeah.
That wasn't right what word. I had yeah. in mind.
Oh, would it help if he tackled you? Would that make it all good?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, okay. I haven't heard about any issues, I'm sorry.
No, that's fine. I thought you were a Karenish for some reason. I think,
the belt buckle?
Well, that wasn't it. I keep forgetting they have a belt buckle. That's, Mm-hmm. No, we,
yeah, most big families do.
Yeah, we were accused of, shooting someone up in Strawberry earlier the other day.
Oh.
Oh. Well, I haven't heard about that.
No, fair enough. Funny enough, we were speaking with your dad while it happened.
Oh.
And then he came down to the ranch after saying it was us that did it, but we were all talking to your father when the shooting happened.
Yeah, well, that makes sense, confusing. Doesn't it? Mm-hmm.
That does seem very confusing, a little bit weird. But I'm not.
Yeah, I don't know
I'm
what's going on there.
Yeah, I'm not good at politics, so I'm not. I'm usually kept away from it, also because I'm a doctor, so I have to be neutral.
Yeah, well, your father would be similar, right? If he's a.
Yeah, he would
a
have to.
A lawyer or a. What's the word? Why is he. Frederick, he's something. Something to the DA or something like that.
Yeah,
right?
He's studying to become something.
Yeah, what's it called? It's called something.
I don't know. Ain't my name.
Academic, or what are you referring to?
Oh, I'm struggling. Something, No, it's alright. It'll come to me. No, it's alright. It's something to do with a lawyer.
Alright.
Well, does that mean we have issues? Because you have issues with the Cavendish. Do I have issues with you now, too?
No, the only issue I have with you is that you keep throwing me on the ground, but no, I don't have no issue with the Cavendish. None at all.
I don't think I have ever thrown anyone on the ground.
Maybe I'm mistaken, could have.
Yeah, well, we might have a family war soon then. Or you guys. I'm not part of the Cavendish family, but I hope to be a good friend to them at least. I try to be.
Yeah, no, we don't have a problem with the Cavendish, but somebody using your family's name has a problem with us.
Huh. Well, that sounds stupid.
Little bit.
What the hell do I do with a lizard foot? Do I sell it?
No, you boil it and eat it.
I'm trying to.
But I can't.
Come on, Frederick, we get out of here. Christ. Goodbye. Goodbye,
yeah,
people.
Goodbye.
See you soon.
Goodbye. Oh my god.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Auf Wiedersehen. Cheers. Where the hell my hat go? Jesus.
Uh-oh. There's so many hats now. Look at all that.
Look good with my hand!
Thank you!
You're welcome! Oh. Me on my... Should we get matching outfits later? That would be fun.
Matching doctor's outfit? That could be kind of
fun. Yeah, that would be fun.
I do kind of like that we're both wearing corsets. I like that.
Yeah, I like that too. You having some fun wrestling around?
Yeah, we were doing some training.
Yeah, we were doing some training too. Where the hell am I? You stole my head! Well.
I think I'm gonna go to bed instead, because I actually just came on to work a little bit. Because I had some documents I had to file out. Like, OOC work. And I'm in a long line, so... And I'm done with my work now. This is... So, yes. I'll be back on tomorrow morning, because it's 1 a.m. here. Bye, everyone, and thank you for watching.